eBay Motors. Let's ride.
93.5 and 107.5. The Fan.
WIBC HD2 W298BB. WIBC HD3 W228CX. Indianapolis.
It's Kevin and Querry.
I throw, you catch. It's not that hard, okay? All right, get the out of here.
I'm going to talk a lot about drills and fundamentals.
Watch it.
On 93.5.
Watch it.
And 107.5.
Boom, baby.
The Fan.
We are certainly getting closer. Good Wednesday morning to you. Kevin Bowen, Jake Querry, and Mark Dykton. This was probably the time, I feel like, every year where it was like, is the clock going to move any freaking faster to December 25th?
Do you remember, as a kid, did you have any of the countdown devices, the little...
Yeah, and we currently have one for Rosie, which I had as a kid. It's like a snowman, and you move the snowflake like one day.
Okay.
You know, it's 1 through 25, and
we
you
had,
move
I
it
think,
one day.
I think we had a... You know, it was like a house with the windows, and each one had like
a candy
or something in it.
We don't really follow the day by day, though. We like to jump days, so our math may be more reminiscent of your days in Lawrence versus what you're doing right now.
Fair enough. It was, you know, you tell me if this sounds crazy, Kevin, because I thought about this and maybe part of it, I don't know, but as Christmas draws closer, or Hanukkah, which we're in day four, I believe, whatever you may celebrate this time of year. To me, the whole like magic of the season, from the music to the traditions, everything else, is it awakens the nostalgia that allows for the memories of people who are long past to like kind of be alive still.
Yeah, I think that's
like,
what
I think of my grandparents every year. I think of like the traditions of when I was a kid. And my Aunt Dottie and my Uncle Walt and my grandparents and people that are no longer around. But because I do that every year, it allows their memory to be very vivid as opposed to fade over the course of time.
Yeah, I would agree with that. And then kind of on the other end of the life spectrum, and we're really feeling it this first year, Mark certainly felt it for a couple of years, just seeing like Rosie's pure joy.
Oh, I'm sure.
Is awesome. And just, again, how much she just lights up at whatever Christmas-related activity we are doing is absolutely awesome. So, again, safe travels to everybody out there, whether it's Hanukkah, Kwanzaa, Christmas. This time of year, of course, is a busy travel season, and we'll continue to keep you updated weather-wise. I know Friday, it probably is a good thing we don't have the show on Friday because it continues to look a little dicey Thursday night into Friday morning from a wind and temperature standpoint. The snow totals don't look quite alarming here. I thought I saw yesterday like a handful of inches, maybe.
That's good, because there was some thought.
Because Chicago, Mark, is what, like a foot?
If not more.
You know, my running joke every year, but it's true, is how in the world Mother Nature knows exactly where I-70 is. Because literally every year it's like, now just north of 70, it's crazy. But
and then the 500, 465 blocks all the showers, right?
That's true. That is right. You know, the one thing that I say, and I know I'm annoying when I do it, but the one thing that I will say, folks, please keep this in mind, especially over the next 72 hours. If you've got, even if they are predominantly outdoor pets, if you've got them, move them inside the next 3 days.
Yeah, you know, last night I'm sitting there watching IU and Elon and thought, boy, Xavier Johnson trying to get around campus on that scooter is going to be a little difficult this time of year.
Yeah, you're right.
Be some icy patches for him. Indiana handles...
And you don't want him driving.
I didn't even think about that part. That's certainly true. Yeah, a lot of A-bus trips for Xavier Johnson coming up. 96-72 over Elon last night. Purdue will get back into action tonight. They've got New Orleans at 9 o'clock. It's a late tip for Mackey. I think it's on ESPNU, so some TV probably played into that. And the Pacers, after a couple nights off, they will face the Boston Celtics. That is a 7:30 tip for the Pacers. Jake, first time seeing Malcolm Brogdon this year.
And he's been a nice player for them. You know, I think Malcolm Brogdon probably in Boston, that's probably the best role for him. I think he's a really good player. He has the ability to do a number of different things. He can do each of those things really well when called upon to do so. But when everything was on his shoulders, it wasn't that he played poorly in it, but I don't know that everybody else ran off of him. So I think he's a better reactionary player than he is getting people to react to him. But he's done a nice job in Boston.
Yeah, I thought Boston presented the opportunity very well. We don't need you to come here and play 38 minutes. We need you to come off the bench, be the lead guy for that second unit. We'll happily let you rest at different points during the season. We get your injury history, all those things. And I think we saw it in the finals last year. They just didn't have kind of that lead guard to go to in those moments. So he's only playing 23 minutes off the bench, but it has been very effective, particularly as a scorer for them. So the Pacers will see him tonight, of course. And as we mentioned yesterday, this is the hardest stretch, I think, of the season, three-game stretch when you look at Boston tonight, at Miami on Friday. I know the Pelicans have lost a few, but still that'll be a challenge at New Orleans coming up on Monday for Indiana. The Colts made a couple of interesting roster moves yesterday we can get to. The Colts have not been very active on the roster move front this season, but a couple of, I think, notable names. Hometown kid coming to Indy as well. And they cut, honestly, one of their more effective players
this season. I was going to say, were you surprised by that?
Yeah, Fadio Deniabo got cut yesterday, and I guess to describe him, he's number 59, the dude that does the sword dance after each sack. It's a very nice dance. Great rhythm, I feel like. He's very effective with it. It's I enjoy seeing it, to be honest with you. But yeah, he got cut yesterday, and I guess I had two initial thoughts, Jake. One was, did he request this? Does he say, hey, it's late in the year. I've kind of been a journeyman. I'd like to be picked up by a playoff team. That was my first thought. My second thought was, did they cut him because of the penalty at the end of the game?
I mean,
he was the guy that was laying on, was it Jefferson or Hawkinson? I kind of forget who it was.
I think it was Jefferson.
You know, Jeff Saturday expressed frustration at that penalty after the game, but it wasn't to the point of like, that penalty cost us the game. You know, it wasn't like to that degree. But this is a guy that's had, I think, like 3.5 sacks for you coming off the bench, has been easily your best rotational edge rusher. I found that move interesting yesterday.
The Jonathan Taylor news, I don't think is necessarily of surprise, Kevin. Were you surprised that they IR'd him as opposed to just, I mean, I guess you create a spot there.
Right. I think that's exactly what it is. Now, but did you see who they promoted to the 53-man roster to take a spot?
I did. They went back to familiarity, right?
Yeah, and Jordan Wilkins. You know, Wilkins has had such an interesting career to me. He's averaged nearly 5 yards per carry in his NFL career. That is a big number. And it's not like he's ripped off. It's not like he has 70 carries in his career and two of them went for 80. So that can be like a very skewed number. No, he's had over 200 carries in his career and doesn't have an 80 or 70 yarder that can, again, really skew things. So right now it looks like for Monday night, and I don't know, maybe no one cares about this. Maybe some people on fantasy teams care about it. Zach Moss, Deion Jackson, and Jordan Wilkins. That will be your trio Monday night, and I assume that will be your trio the rest of the season. But I will reiterate what I said yesterday about Taylor. I get the injury is not a torn Achilles. It's not a torn ACL. But how the Colts handle Taylor's contract extension coming up this offseason and or Michael Pittman's contract extension, I think is going to be a fascinating storyline in an offseason with many, many storylines.
Does this officially, Kevin, insert Jake jumps to conclusions here? Does this, and by the way, good morning to you. My name is Jake Query. That is Kevin Bowen. Mark Dykton here as well. Mark, you awake?
Well, yeah, sure.
Sounds like
no cereal, Mark.
Yeah,
no cereal, not yet. No.
Late start.
Too many
been
things
up for a while?
To bring. It's too many things. I'm trying to not bring so much stuff.
Okay. No cereal. Minimalist. Bowl, Mark spoon, Dykton over here.
Milk.
Are you living in one of the tiny houses now?
No.
Okay.
Should I?
Such a millennial, you.
You sound like a millennial minimalist, right? No.
Zero bars for me.
Boy, say
it
that
is
three
a Wednesday
times
morning.
Fast.
Well, I'm a tongue twisting champion, 1990 North Central High School, Jay Everlight Career Center Radio and TV program. Thank you. So I could probably do that, Mark, but I'll lay off.
Thank you for that. That's the greatest Christmas gift I've ever received.
Wednesday morning here on 93.5, 107.5, The Fan. Does this mean yesterday, Kevin, in looking at it, and Jonathan Taylor going to IR, Have the Colts officially, even though they are still mathematically alive, and even though they will tell us that they're all chips in and everything else, does this officially mean they punted on the season?
With what move?
They realize there's nothing left to play for.
With Taylor going IR?
Yeah, with Taylor.
No, I think it's a high ankle sprain, and I think he's legitimately out for 3 or 4 weeks. I guess if you were to have the Christmas miracles of all Christmas miracles and make the playoffs, could Taylor return at some point in January? Sure. But I think it's a guy that's had three different occasions this season where the ankle injury has sidelined him. And for a guy that's never been hurt, I mean, literally never been hurt in his football career, NFL, college, high school, I think it's fine to shut him down. I don't think it's a punt. I think it's a very wise move by the Colts in doing this. And is it at all, is it at all insult to injury? Is this one of your buddies?
Yes, it is.
Okay.
Scotty must have let him in.
Yeah, I was a little rattled. You know, I'm not used to people over my shoulder.
Usually Scotty will
never heard you say yo before.
7:10 in the morning.
You can sit right over there.
Does it at all add insult to injury that for the second year in a row the Jacksonville Jaguars could eliminate the Colts from the playoffs tomorrow night?
Do you go Jaguars or Jaguars?
Boy, whatever I just said. What did I say?
Well, here we're going to take two on that. Just where as
Jacksonville Jaguars.
Mark, that's
two different things. He said two different ways.
No, I think he said Jaguars both times.
Duh.
Yeah, it's definitely Jaguars, but you went with Wires. That's okay though.
Wires is probably more Indiana, right?
Have you seen The Wire?
A little bit,
greatest,
not like...
Greatest television show ever made.
You and Stephen Holder, love it.
It's the greatest TV show ever made, The Wire is, and the thing I love about it is there are no wasted episodes in it. If the Colts were to play Jacksonville at the end of the year and again be eliminated, it would be a repeat of an episode we've seen before and thought we'd never see again, and it's indicative of two franchises probably going in different directions, right? Because the Colts, as we've talked about, I mean, you know, they're stuck in that vat of suck, and the Jaguars look like they've kind of turned a corner, but the question becomes, is that fool's gold? They've beaten some good teams here lately. Can you imagine how much it would irk Jim Irsay if he sees his franchise again eliminated by the Jaguars?
Jacksonville beats New York tomorrow night. Colts officially eliminated. Second year in a row.
All chips.
End. Okay. Can we get, you know what we need to do? Mark, you don't have a, now I'm assuming that none of the three of us own one of these, okay?
A private jet?
Close. Very close. Very close. A hairdryer.
My wife has one.
Of course.
Yeah.
When we went on vacation and we got to the hotel and Shannon freaks out because I booked a hotel that didn't have a hairdryer. And I'm like, sorry.
Doesn't that usually come with the room?
Well, they said they'd leave the light on for us, and I thought, well, this Motel 6, as they called it where we were, I figured it'd be nice, right?
I don't know if that was one of your better jokes.
I'm just saying. Now, but we could just get a blow dryer to run and then make comments, and it sounds like we're Jim Irsay in front of the private jet, because that's exactly what that sounded like, right? When he's, but we haven't heard that in a while.
Colts get a Pro Bowler tonight?
No.
Yes.
They do. I think they do.
They will get, I'm thinking aloud here.
I'd put it in order, Nelson, Buckner, Gilmore.
That's exactly right. I think that's exactly right.
This one for Mr. Gilmore.
Thank you, Mark. I think...
And I'd love to flip that just so Mark can play that a little bit
realistically,
more.
I think Buckner should probably be one over Nelson.
The thing about the AFC, Jake, there are some great defensive tackles in the AFC. And I think that is what hurts DeForest Buckner. Again, Grover Stewart, Zaire Franklin, absolutely deserve consideration. Absolutely.
Remember, Gilmore has played very well. And
he's got name recognition league-wide, right, which I think will really help his cause. But remember when Darius Leonard missed the Pro Bowl when he was leading the league in tackles? Like, it usually takes, and again, Grover Stewart kind of has a similar background to Leonard in that he didn't go to this mega school and... I think that is a big deal, honestly, because it is a bit of a popularity contest. Again, a third fan vote, third player, third coach. That's how you get the Pro Bowl. It'll be announced tonight on NFL Network. But, yeah, I would put it in that order.
Now,
Nelson,
the
Buckner,
Pro Bowl, though,
Gilmore.
This is different than, everybody going out to Aloha Stadium the week before or after the Super Bowl. And so what is the Pro Bowl exactly now? This is everybody goes and plays Twister. Is that what happens?
I think a little bit of Twister, maybe like tic-tac-toe on the beach.
Right.
Is it Vegas?
Well, there's no beach in Vegas.
I know. Well, you can manufacture a beach or two in Vegas.
You can go out to the dam there. What's the, is it Lake Havasu that's like dried up and they're finding all kinds of gangster bodies?
Hoover Dam?
Hoover Dam, I'm sorry. But well, what's the lake that it forms?
Boy, sounds about right, yeah.
Can't say that's on my news gathering radar right now.
Oh, are you kidding me?
Hoover Dam. I have not been Hoover
Dam. The water's retreating, and as a result, like barrels with old gangsters are floating up. It's awesome.
Skills competition, I think, is what it's turned into. Yeah. Maybe a little flag football, but it, obviously it's more for the recognition.
No flag football on the beach. Ask Robert Edwards, the Patriots running back.
Yeah,
he ended his career doing that. But regardless, though, it is where this year?
I thought it was in Vegas.
So it's like the Battle of the Network Stars and the AFC versus NFC, and they get everybody gets a ribbon, right?
Peyton, is it Peyton and Eli, the captains? They had DeMarcus Ware and Ray Lewis on the ManningCast Monday night. I think they're involved in it. As, again, it's more for a recognition standpoint. And, again, I know it can kind of be a popularity contest, but
Lake Mead, by the way. Thank you, everybody. Lake Mead.
Players
now, they also
care.
Make the Trapper Keepers, right?
Oh, isn't boy. Trappers right? used to be a big deal.
Did you have a Trapper Keeper?
I had a Trapper.
In my opinion, that sucked.
What are you talking about, Mark? That's brilliant. That's a great recall from the 80s. Did you not have a Trapper Keeper?
Yeah, I had a Trapper Keeper.
Okay, well, that then joke, what do you have against Mead?
That joke stunk.
I thought that was decent.
Yeah, thank you.
Just difference so of opinion.
Huh? Well,
difference of opinion there.
Listen, why don't you go back to your non-breakfast morning and let us know when you're awake?
I am awake.
It got the vibe from Parks Frazier yesterday, again, coordinator day for the Colts, that Matt Ryan, he's game planning as if Matt Ryan will be the quarterback on Monday night against the Chargers. Jeff Saturday will meet the media today for confirmation. I mean, a question that I have for Jeff Saturday, Jake, is what are you saying to your locker room when the guy that leads the league in interceptions and fumbles, and he's not giving you anywhere near big play? I mean, you're in the basement of the NFL in big plays. It's not like he's offsetting those turnovers with big plays. What message does that send your locker room that that guy keeps his job, and yet you've cut and fired and benched many others this season?
We have Matt Ryan.
I think the message was sent.
Because, again, Jeff Saturday's not tanking. He's not trying to tank. He literally thinks Matt Ryan is the best option.
Understood. Kevin, there is too much dysfunction on this team, and there have been too many monkey wrenches thrown into the plan for the roster to think anything other than it's chaos and they are looking towards the future. There's no way, if you're a member of that team and you see the owner come down and edict a young quarterback who's never started a game in the NFL, starts two games, you lose both of those, then you fire the coach, you bring in a guy that's never coached before, that the night before you were watching on ESPN, and now all of a sudden he's in your locker room gathering you up, giving you a speech, getting you ready to go out there. You go out in games, your star running back, who was one of the best players and dynamic game changers in the league, gets nicked up, so they shelf him for the year. They cut a guy that was fairly productive for you. You blew a 33-point lead. If these guys are in any way, shape, or form thinking anything other than reading tea leaves that their franchise is chaotic and total disarray and has punted on the season, then I don't know what to tell them, because they ought to just go back to watching like Matlock or something and consider that to be their investigative skill, because it is obvious to everyone, right? They're done.
But
they're done.
They aren't, like, Irsay and Saturday are not trying to punt. They're trying to win.
Kevin, I was trying to get a D in algebra when I had a 22% my freshman year,
like,
also.
Why are you calling 29-year-old Jordan Wilkins up from the practice squad?
Right.
Why wouldn't you be all in on some young dude to call up? I mean, they aren't committing to youth everywhere.
They can say what they want, and they can, at this point,
isn't that scary, though?
Push in how they want, but they've already screwed it up. They're in total chaos. And the good news is they have pieces and talent on the roster where it's not a completely irreparable damage, if that's an irreversible damage, for next season, I'm saying. But for this year, it's over. It's over.
Again, $17 million financial dangling of the carrot in playing Matt Ryan. If you were to get hurt, unable to pass a physical come March, you would owe him $17 million on top of, I believe it's 12, Kevin, that he's already guaranteed for next.
Let me tell you the two season. Times, the two things of like disappointment and an incredulous wave that I've noticed about Colts fans in the last 20 years. One of them was when Mike Vanderjagt's kick sailed right against Pittsburgh. I was in the RCA Dome. I was coming down to go downstairs to go into the locker room for post game. As Vanderjagt was lining up for that kick, as the elevator doors opened, I could literally, it was like when you used to walk out of the RCA Dome and that huge breeze would blow you out from the air pressure. That's what it felt like from the collective breathe in, holy cow, of 56,000 people at the RCA Dome when he missed that kick. Okay, that was one. And then the other one was when I was at Yuletide on Saturday. Yes, my apologies to those who think that I should have been glued in front of the television instead of with my parents and the rest of my family at a Yuletide anniversary celebration. But nonetheless, I digress. As I was at the Yuletide at the intermission, when everybody in the place looked at their phones and saw the Colts were up 33-0, there was a gasp of incredulous, what in the world are they doing? They're going to screw this up. Disappointment that they actually finally decided to play well. Because people like, there's nothing to be gained by winning this game. Come on, reach into the grasps of fortitude and find a loss, please. And thank goodness they did.
If the Colts lose out, they will have a top five pick. Again, Rams and Cardinals this weekend. So that guarantees the Colts will move up a spot in the draft order. They're currently sixth, assuming that they lose on Monday night. Is it still a four-point spread Monday with the Chargers, Mark?
Last I checked, yeah.
What do you mean last year? Are you awake this morning?
Yes, I don't check constantly.
This is what you're the fact checker of the program.
Chargers minus -4. Tomorrow night, Jags at Jets. The Jets a one-point favorite in that one.
What do we do on this program, Mark?
We educate and entertain.
Okay. Did you agree to both this morning?
No, I did not.
This is I don't know, did you guys see this earlier today? I mean, very unfortunate news, considering the celebration that will be occurring in Pittsburgh on Saturday night. You see Franco Harris passed?
Did he really?
Yeah, I saw that.
Holy cow. No, I did not see that. Had he been ill?
Don't believe I saw anything on that end. 72 years old, and for those that are unfamiliar with Saturday in Pittsburgh, it's the 50th year anniversary of the Immaculate Reception. It's Raiders at Steelers. So
he was scheduled to be there, I assume, right?
Certainly. There's a reason why they put that game as the solo Christmas Eve night game.
Frenchie Fuqua is who that pass was intended for. I don't believe...
Who was the Raider defender?
Probably Jack Tatum. Right?
Yeah, I was going to say. The assassin. It was a familiar name.
They were going to retire his jersey at the game as well, apparently.
Really?
We had
God,
that's
like such a scary story.
Yeah.
So Franco Harris, we had on when I did the afternoon show during the Super Bowl in 2012 on Radio Row. He came on. He was a very, very, very nice guy. Had a fun spirit about him. I think I asked him, and I'm sure he's not lived a day in his life since, of, you know, hey, did the ball touch the ground? Because that's always been the controversy with the Immaculate Reception. Was it an incomplete pass, or did he scoop it up before it touched the ground? Camera angles, there's no way to know that. He ran into, not to say this about him posthumously, but it's not huge or egregious, but he was a little bit controversial during the Penn State Joe Paterno, the whole thing that took place with what, I can't believe I just spaced the name of the defensive coordinator that got in trouble at Penn State. Sandusky.
Jerry Sandusky.
During the Jerry Sandusky trials, Franco Harris said some things that were a little bit like, whoa, dude, really? Like, you might want to scale that back a little bit. And I think that disappointed some people. But a great player, and in the very, you know, I don't know him, obviously, but when I was around him, a really, really nice person. So that is sad, especially considering the timing.
You know, obviously, like, Pittsburgh Steelers history, I don't know how rich it is in terms of everyone like having an immense knowledge base of it, but you know, that was their first career playoff win as a franchise, that game.
Yeah.
And then they go on to win 4 Super Bowls in the next, what, 8 years, something like that. So it's pretty crazy how everything unfolded on that. Did you watch any of Indiana last night? Jalen Hood-Schifino had 17, did have 5 turnovers. I think natural point guard is going to be an issue for Indiana for weeks, maybe the rest of the season.
Would tend to agree. They listen, with Xavier Johnson, you miss two things. Number one would be that just kind of a floor general, but also his ability to shoot from outside. Now, it was feast or famine with Johnson for certain. But when he was going, he was a really good, reliable outside shooter. And handling the basketball and shooting from the outside. I thought one of the silver linings for Indiana, and it's very tough to tell because it's Elon, not Illinois, right? But CJ Gunn, I thought, gave him some minutes. And
Freshman, Caleb Banks, played well.
And CJ Gunn is one that I've heard people say that I think he thought he would get more minutes at this point than he has. I guess any player would feel that way. I'll be curious to see what his role is moving forward within the team.
Yeah, I mean, Hood-Shifino obviously is a really good player and very skilled, but again, just not that natural point guard. So I think if Xavier Johnson's going to miss a huge chunk of time, what you miss with that is the ability to, you have to have Hood-Shifino pretty much be your point guard, and you can't play him off the ball, which I think he would rather do. I don't think he was a full-time point guard in his high school days. So I think those are questions that Indiana will have. Again, 7 assists, but also 5 turnovers last night, and I don't think Elon is pressuring the ball like some Big Ten teams will do. It was kind of wild to see Elon had 8 scholarship players. No Trace Jackson Davis last night for Indiana, precautionary reasons. I've been dealing with a little bit of a back. Again, no Xavier Johnson, and no Jordan Geronimo either. He had a little wrap on his left.
Did you see that IUPUI got a win over Texas A&M University Commerce?
Yes. So that, I mean, that's a nice win, right?
Yeah.
Well, I mean, any win for the Jags,
3-10,
right?
3-10, right?
I saw that New Orleans, who Purdue's playing tonight, the Privateers, by the way, that's their nickname. They have 1 Division I win on the year, and it's over the Jags.
Really?
Yeah.
I thought you were going to say it's over Texas A&M University.
No.
Now, this is interesting about TAMU Commerce. They're 4-9.
I thought it used to be Corpus Christi. Did it get changed?
3 of those 4 wins they actually traded for. That's one of their specialties down there, just so you know, at the university. That's what really.
In my opinion, that sucked.
Did you bring your buddy here in the corner to laugh at your jokes? No. Because he just gave you a sympathy laugh.
No, his dad, Tom Hadley, I grew up with, and his mom, for that matter.
Name again? I felt bad. I don't know his name.
This would be Griffin Hadley. He's a swimmer at the University of Tennessee.
Good to see you. Wow, that's big.
Yeah, he swam at Carmel. I mean,
really big.
We're actually among somebody that's accomplished some crap in high school.
Right, you know I just mean? Jumped in the Carmel swimming pool, Cannonball!
Mark, you wear a Speedo much?
Every day.
Okay.
Boy, sure. Griffin, welcome in studio. Kevin Bowen, Jake Query, Mark Dykton, Stephen Holder are going to join us at 8 o'clock. We'll talk some college basketball with Mike DeCourcy at 9. And it's kind of like an annual conversation we have. This week, the G League Showcase out in Vegas, they are using the Elam ending. Again, Nick Elam, Ball State professor, created this ending. We've seen it in the NBA All-Star Game. So we'll get an update on that if it continues to have some traction to gain steam on a professional basketball landscape. Pretty nice commute in on this Wednesday morning before the weather turns later in the week. Thanks for tuning in. Kevin Query.
The reality is, though, that winning that game would have done them nothing. To have the resiliency, the guts, the fortitude, the leadership of men.
I know I can lead men.
To reach down deep inside and still allow Minnesota to keep them within striking distance of the top 6 in the draft.
If you're talking about it.
It takes a special skill set to be able to do it that way.
We're talking about it.
They can actually move up another spot tonight.
Your home for indie sports. 93.5 and 107.5. The Fan.
Guys, solve your ED today with an intimacy guarantee only at the Indianapolis Men's Clinic. If you don't perform, you don't pay. Call the Indianapolis Men's Clinic. At 999-9000, 999-9000.
Crew Car Wash books make the perfect holiday gift. And right now, buy 4 Ultimate Washes and get 2 free. Available online or at any Crew Car Wash location.
It's the Colts VIP tailgate presented by Hayes & Sons Restoration. Make your game day experience the best it can be. Log on and get your tickets now. It's BullseyeEventGroup.com.
Will they find a home? Sponsored by Geico. Steve is intrigued by the paranormal.
Otherworldly spirits really make a house a home, you know?
Janice has different taste.
I'd like my house to not be haunted.
Compromise is tough, but these two won't have to compromise when they bundle home and car insurance with Geico. It's easy, and they could save even more. In the end, Steve and Janice found a renovated Victorian that's only haunted from 9 to 5.
Okay, wife's home. Y'all gotta bounce.
Bye, Steve.
Bundling without compromise at geico.com.
Football season is underway, so now is the perfect time to download FanDuel, America's number one sportsbook. Because right now, new customers get a no-sweat first bet up to $1,000. Just sign up with promo code PLAY. FanDuel has all your favorite bets from the money line to point spreads to player props. So sign up today with promo code PLAY for your no-sweat first bet. Make every moment more this season with FanDuel, official sportsbook partner of the NFL.
21 plus in select states. First online real money wager only. Refund issued as non-withdrawable free bets that expires in 14 days. Restrictions apply. See terms at sportsbook.fanduel.com. Gambling problem? Call 1-800-GAMBLER or visit fanduel.com/RG in Colorado, Iowa, Michigan, New Jersey, Pennsylvania, Illinois, and Virginia. 1-800-NEXT-STEP or text NEXTSTEP 53342 in Arizona. 1-888-789-7777 or visit ccpg.org/chat in Connecticut. 1-800-9-WITH-IT in Indiana. 1-800-522-4700 or visit ksgamblinghelp.com in Kansas. 1-877-770-STOP Louisiana. 1-877-8-HOPE-NY or text HOPE-NY-467-369 in New York. Tennessee Red Line 1-800-889-9789 in Tennessee. 1-800-522-4700 in Wyoming or visit 1-800-GAMBLER.net in West Virginia.
This holiday, give the people you treasure something they'll treasure. A gift from Shane Company. Our unique jewelry makes a spectacular gift. I'm Tom Shane. One of my favorites is an elegant necklace featuring a colorful east-west gemstone with diamond accents for $250. We offer it in four different gemstones, so you can select a color she loves. Choose red garnet, purple amethyst, sky blue topaz, or yellow citrine. Another favorite are diamond huggy earrings for $1,145. I picked these hoops because they fit close to the ear and are great for any occasion. Select either white gold, yellow gold, or rose gold. Our link necklace at $525 is a favorite because the diamond accents give the gold a touch of sparkle. Visit us for more gifts at a great value. Now you have a friend in the jewelry business. Shane Company and ShaneCo.com.
Remember when you were in your prime and you could work and play hard on a daily basis? Guys, it's time to get that magic back. If you're ready to feel great again, go see Affinity. Affinity Whole Health is the leader in testosterone and hormone replacement therapy. When you start with Affinity, you'll see a jump in your energy, mental focus, and drive. Get started for free at feelgreatindy.com. Then the full hormonal blood panel and medical consult is just $99. Go to feelgreatindy.com today.
Gather near and bring the cheer this holiday season. Dazzle and delight the love of your life with a gift from Helzberg Diamonds. Don't miss great prices on stunning diamond studs, tennis bracelets, gemstone rings, and the year's must-have look, gold jewelry for stacking and layering. Another reason to go to Helzberg? Get a free Microsoft Surface Laptop Go with a purchase of $1,699 or more. Visit Helzberg.com or a store near you today. Limited time offer while supplies last. See online or in store for details.
Hubler has all the top brands. Chevy, Buick, GMC, Ford, Acura, Honda, Mazda, Nissan, and more. And every new vehicle includes a 10-year, 200,000-mile warranty. Looking to sell your vehicle? We'll pay you top dollar, even if you don't buy ours. Take it from Brooke Hubler.
You can get a car anywhere, but you can only get a warranty like this at Hubler. 10 years, 200,000 miles.
Visit drivehubler.com.
Warranty available on new vehicles except certain models not transferable or available on leases. Copy of the warranty is available for review at the dealership.
Hi guys, it's Mark. Are you struggling with erectile dysfunction? Did you know that a major medical breakthrough is now available and it isn't a pill? Today, Wednesday, December 21st, we're running a one-day special you won't want to miss out on. Pine Grove Medical Clinic uses the most powerful form of wave therapy. This is a technology clinically shown to repair blood vessels and improve blood flow. It's backed by 60 clinical studies, including from Cambridge. If you're ready to regain the spark in your bedroom, today is your day. Call us now and you'll qualify for the assessment and ultrasound totally free. You'll also get a gift that can produce rapid and powerful results in the bedroom in minutes. You're going to love that one, guys. Trust me. And today only, we're offering 6 tune-up treatments to our patients free. This is an unprecedented offer worth hundreds of dollars, but call today and qualify totally free. Call 317-552-1111. That's 317-552-1111. Guys, put a stop to your erectile dysfunction and get your life back. Call Pine Grove Medical Clinic now to qualify. This offer ends today, Wednesday, 317-552-1111.
Hey, it's JMV from my guys John and Chris Love at Love Heating and Air Conditioning. Predictions are this could be a colder winter than normal, and you need to make sure your furnace is safe, efficient, and working properly before you have a breakdown on a sub-zero day. Get that recommended service right now from Love Heating and Air Conditioning, and the Love family will waive the $95 trip and diagnostic fee. I trust them, so should you. They're the best. Love-HVAC.com or 317-754-0754. Tell them JMV sent you.
The Morning Checkdown, brought to you by Ball State Basketball. Get your tickets at ballstatesports.com on 93.5 and 107.5 The Fan.
Last night in Bloomington, no Trace Jackson Davis, no Xavier Johnson, no Jordan Geronimo either. Indiana wins 96-72 over Elon. Here was Mike Woodson afterwards on the Hoosiers, getting back to Assembly Hall and getting back in the win column.
Well, again, I mean, tonight everybody had a chance to play. You know, Geronimo came to me before the game and said he couldn't go, and I knew Trace wasn't going to play. And with X being out, you know, guys have got to step up and play and make plays, and I thought for the most part everybody did that. I don't like the fact that we gave up 72 points. You know, that's something I always seem to watch. So we got to be better in that area.
Jake, no update on Xavier Johnson. The pictures don't look good. Scootering it around, big old boot on that foot. Again, some whispers of a broken foot. He's going to miss time, substantial time.
I realize that it's just kind of lost in translation of the message, but it does not sound great, does it, when a coach says, yeah, before the game he came up to me and told me he can't go. I mean, I would assume that that means that Tim Garl told Geronimo, like, hey, you can't go, and then he went and relayed the message, right?
Yeah.
As opposed to say, hey, you know what? Like this morning,
I got to go study at Wells tonight.
Yeah, I'm just
going to
tell you guys, I just can't go today, right? I'm just not feeling it. I got lunch later. I'm out.
Although, Mark, it would have been nice if Jake would have given us that warning, you know, last week that he was going to miss the first segment of the show, right?
Was that last week I overslept? That was 2 weeks ago, wasn't it?
I don't know. It's going to happen again, I think. Well, I might not call you this time. You're razzing me a lot this morning. Maybe I'll go up 6:59. We'll see Jake.
You know what? You called me, Mark, because you realized you just can't get through the 3 hours without me.
No, yeah. I have plenty of drops that says otherwise.
If you've got problems with your nip. Thank you. Not your nips. Yeah. That's for sure.
Jalen Hood-Schifino, 17 points last night, 7 assists, did have 5 turnovers. He is the point guard right now without Xavier Johnson. Trey Galloway, I got some minutes at point as well. Good work from the freshman. CJ Gunn, 11 off the bench for the LN product, and Caleb Banks had some nice run as well.
Elsewhere in college basketball, it was IUPUI 62-52, as we mentioned, over Texas A&M Commerce. Is that formerly Corpus Christi?
You got to think, right?
Do we know what their mascot is?
How many Texas A&M CCs are there?
That's a good point.
Didn't Kevin say they're the privateers, or is that somebody else? No,
that's New Orleans. Corpus Christi used to be the Islanders.
If they're Commerce, they're probably the public tiers, right?
In my opinion, that sucked.
3 for 3.
Pacers-Celtics tonight.
A little liberal on that button.
7:30 tip from Boston. Ironically enough, both teams have lost 4 of 5. I thought it was wild, Jake, when Tony East mentioned to us yesterday the Pacers haven't won 2 in a row since mid-November.
I know, because it doesn't feel like they've...
doesn't feel like they're reeling like that, but they are.
Well, what they're doing, to be honest with you, is, you know, some of the games that they have yet to drop games. I shouldn't say that for the most part. You know,
win one, lose one. Win one, lose one.
Correct. Like, they're not losing games where you're like, what?
Besides that Nets game,
I hate to say they're kind of losing to the games that you expected them heading into to lose, but it does get thick now. The schedule hits reality here for a little bit. It's going to be a tough stretch.
10-point underdog tonight at Boston.
The Texas A&M Commerce team, Dr. Muttman might be a fan favorite of their mascot.
The Lions?
There you go.
Are they really?
Mm-hmm. My mind went with the hearts.
Exactly. Threading the needles?
Yeah.
The catheters?
The pulmonaries.
For the Boilermaker fans, you got to stay up late tonight. Purdue, number one in the nation, of course. They take on New Orleans. That is a 9 o'clock tip. Purdue favored by 33.5.
Oh, you got to take the half there, right?
New Orleans 3-7 on the year. Like I mentioned, IUPUI, their only Division I win. Zach Edey's putting up like Shaquille O'Neal numbers this season.
I know.
And gets doubled all day long.
And it's interesting. He's still not seen, and I get it. I understand why the game has changed. He's not seen as necessarily a dynamic, can't-miss NBA prospect.
Yeah, the NBA debate on Edey will be fascinating.
Yeah, for sure. Because I do think that there is a place for him in the league, but somebody's going to have to kind of cater around what he brings on the floor because he does not play the NBA style today.
His ability, though, to the stamina he's shown this season and playing as many minutes as he has, and he stayed out of foul trouble for the most part, which, again, for a guy 7'4 and how they officiate, Edie, extremely impressive. So Purdue back at home at Mackey. Again, they've played a lot of games away from home here as of late. In the news that we woke up to, just tragic news out of Pittsburgh, Franco Harris passes at the age of 72. Obviously, the passing speaks for itself, but he was supposed to be honored. And Mark, you said his jersey retired this Saturday night.
Mm-hmm.
The 50th anniversary of the Immaculate Reception, Raiders at Steelers. This was a game that the NFL purposefully placed in that Saturday night, Christmas Eve, 8 o'clock window. Obviously, tons of events around the anniversary coming up this weekend. And
it simply says that his son, tone. Doc Harris, told the Associated Press that Harris had died overnight and no cause of death has been given. Again, 72 years old, 12,000 career rushing yards, and really kind of a cornerstone of, you know, he and Rocky Blyer both, every once in a while you have players that just kind of represent and take on the tenor, the attitude, and the feel of a city. And Pittsburgh, in particular in the 70s, was just a blue-collar, workhorse, you know, factory-type town. And that's what Franco Harris was seen as. In terms of running backs, he was not the flashy slash, ironically, of a guy that played collegiately in Pittsburgh and Tony Dorsett. You know, and he wasn't necessarily the straight-up, the gut runner of a Larry Zonka, but he was just a workhorse guy, right, that was that kind of, I think, exceeded what people expected for him. 12,120 rushing yards in his career, 4 Super Bowl rings for Franco Harris. Again, 1972 is when the Immaculate Reception took place. Franco Harris passes away at the age of 72.
First Steelers playoff victory, and of course led to many Super Bowls in the 70s and beyond. When we come back, the Colts made a roster move yesterday. They've acquired an Indianapolis native. We'll explain more coming up next here. Stephen Holder, 8 o'clock.
The Pacers are in Boston to take on the powerful Celtics tonight at 7 on 93.5 and 107.5 The Fan.
Santa's little helpers are making their way from the North Pole to Twin Peaks. Join them December 20th through 24th for their Red Hot Costume Party. Get specials on their favorite drafts and cocktails and more. Merry Christmas from Twin Peaks. And if you've been to Twin Peaks, you're already a fan. But have you joined their e-club? Signing up is easy. Just visit twinpeaksrestaurant.com/peak-club today to score free stuff and get started today.
Twin Peaks. Eats, drinks, scenic views.
All your last-minute holiday needs are at Payless Liquors. Jim Beam 12 Days of Whiskey is $6.99, and Stirling's 12 Days of Cocktails, $34.99. Plus, Payless has assorted candy canes, great for parties and gifts. And all 26 Payless stores have Kendall Jackson Vintners Reserve Chardonnay for $9.99 a bottle, and Svedka 80 Proof in the large 1.75 liter for only $14.99. Payless Liquors, open late on Christmas Eve, and select stores open Christmas Day. Don't pay more, get more, and pay less at Payless Liquors.
Merry Christmas, everyone. This is Dave Magine with B&W Plumbing and Heating. We all know Santa doesn't fix furnaces, but B&W Plumbing and Heating does. We're here to be sure you have a warm and enjoyable Christmas. Check us out at bigblacktrucks.com or call us at 317-243-3581. That's 317-243-3581. And from our family to yours, Merry Christmas, everyone. And remember the reason for the season.
B&W is your trusted local independent American Standard heating and air conditioning dealer.
At Eskenazi Health, our patients are treated with compassion and skill. That's why Eskenazi Health is looking for professionals who share our mission and are dedicated to serving the community. As an employee of Indiana's top hospital for social responsibility and community health investment, you'll enjoy excellent benefits, competitive pay, and unwavering leadership support. Learn more about Eskenazi Health Careers online at eskenazihealth.edu/careers.
Your love isn't confined to an advent calendar. It doesn't stop when the Christmas lights come down. With the Salvation Army, your love lasts all year long. It puts a present under someone's tree today and a roof over someone's head tomorrow. It brightens Christmas morning and the hardest nights for hardworking families. Together, we love beyond Christmas. Give $25 a month to support local families all year long at SalvationArmyIndiana.org.
Join Mark Patrick Seminars and lose the weight guaranteed, only $49.99. Also, stop smoking with Mark Patrick. This hypnosis is designed to destroy your desire to smoke without cravings, irritability, weight gain, or your money back. Seminars Thursday, January 19th at the Holiday Inn Express and Suites in Noblesville. Weight loss 5:30 p.m. Stop smoking 8 p.m. And Saturday, January 21st at the Holiday Inn Indianapolis Airport. Weight loss 11 a.m. Stop smoking 2 p.m. Register at markpatrickseminars.com.
I always wanted to learn Spanish, but I never thought I'd have the time. Then I discovered Babbel.
Babbel's lessons are fun. They only take like 10 or 15 minutes, and in 3 weeks, presto, you're starting to speak another language, like magic.
I love that Babbel's lessons aren't just robots talking. They're voiced by native speakers, so you get the pronunciation just right.
If you want to learn a language, there's no faster, easier, better way than
Babbel.
Babbel.
Babbel. Go to Babbel.com to try for free. That's B-A-B-B-E-L.com. Babbel.com.
Knockouts Haircuts for Men is the new place to trust with your hair care and grooming.
Knockouts is a high-end full-service salon for men. They pamper you while you relax and enjoy precision cut. Top-notch stylists and barbers.
Every style.
Cuts, fades, all hair types. Beard care, color, and waxing available.
At Knockouts, get a complimentary beverage with any service.
Knockouts Haircuts for Men.
Two Indy locations.
US 36 and Avon next to Tropical Smoothie Cafe. And Clearwater Keystone next to Drake's.
Walk-ins welcome.
Or appointments at 288-0007 or knockouts.com.
Hello, Richard Michalis, president of Michalis Corporation, wishing you a Merry Christmas and Happy Holidays. For over three decades, the Michalis team has helped Central Indiana families and businesses facing fire, water, and storm damage. And because emergencies don't take days off, neither do we. If the unexpected happens this holiday season, we're here for you with our 24/7 rapid disaster response service. Because life happens, water, storms, fire, and foundations, make it Michalis. 844-FIX-INDY.
At the Home Depot, we have the tools for you to give the gift of a smarter home with savings on top brands, like the Google Hub, a command center for your smart devices that raises the IQ of your entire home, or the Nest Learning Thermostat that helps you conserve energy and save on your bill. And if you don't know what to get, gift cards are a smart gift no matter what they get. So this year, gift smarter with savings on tools to make your holiday magic. The Home Depot, how doers get more done.
Here's what's happening with the Fan.
Live from the Slippery Noodle Inn downtown this Thursday, 3 to 6 p.m., join JMB for Larceny Locks and Lunazool Shots. Think you have the best sports trivia knowledge? Listen to Kevin and Query 7 to 10 a.m. and call into the pop quiz for your chance to win a signature Jiffy Lube oil service. And tune into the ride with JMB from 3 to 6 this week for a chance to win tickets to New Year's Eve with Yacht Rock Review at the Murat Theater and Zach Brown Band tickets on August 6th at Ruoff Music Center.
Kevin and Query on 93.5 and 107.5. The Fan.
Jake, we teased before the break, an indie product has joined the Colts here late in the season. And I guess if you think back to the Jack Doyle days playing on 56th Street for Cathedral High School, you go, what, about 2 miles east, you'll hit Lawrence Central, and the Colts signed linebacker Cameron McGrone off of the Patriots practice squad. So he will now join the Colts active roster. Played at Michigan, has not played in the NFL, fifth round pick in 2021. Obviously, linebacker does not on paper look like an immediate need, but if you are Cameron, I would think you would be happy to be back in your hometown. And secondly, you got to look at Bobby Okereke, EJ Speed, both free agents this offseason. Obviously, the Shaquille Leonard injury situation is murky. Might have some chance here to earn a role next season.
It's interesting to me first that the NFL, probably more than any other sport, Kevin, you know, these are the greatest athletes in the world. I mean, obviously, soccer has great athletes, basketball,
football. We've got a swimmer in studio here. Right. Let's come on now.
Yeah, I'm asking Griffin, who swims at Tennessee, you know, so what time do you get up in the morning? Well, I get up every morning at 4 o'clock, and I'm in the pool by 4:30 until 9. I'm thinking, okay. You know, and he comes in here, and I'm telling him it's rough for us to get on at 7, and he's like, yeah, I've swam 4 miles a day by 7
a.m. Yeah, exactly, yeah. It doesn't really fit the Jake Query lifestyle.
But the NFL, though, I mean, you're talking about, in terms of football players, obviously, and physical specimen, the upper crust of the upper crust, the upper tier of the upper quartile, or whatever it is. It is fascinating to me the differences, maybe even like in the style of play or the different things from each respective level. What I'm getting at long-winded is it does amaze me that there is a guy that could play high school football at Lawrence Central or at Northwest High School or at Decatur Central that's playing on Friday nights that is 3 years removed, 4 years removed away from being on an NFL roster, and yet like no one in the stands realizes they're watching a future NFL player. And no one then looks back and goes, oh, I absolutely remember when he was at LC, he was dominant. You know what I mean? Like the way that guys just kind of blend in. Paul Spicer had a really good NFL career for a long time with the Jacksonville Jaguars,
yeah,
primarily.
Defensive lineman.
Yeah. He went to Northwest High School during the time that I was working at Channel 6 and was going and doing Friday night games every Friday night. I have no recollection of him.
Space Pioneers, baby.
Yeah, I don't remember a single person saying, like, you got to come out and see this guy. He's a beast. You know what I mean? Like,
and that was probably more Jack Doyle, honestly, than
Cameron McGrone. That's a good example.
Know, like, Doyle was not this heralded recruit.
You were in high school, was he... I mean, was it like...
He was a good player, and certainly, definitely senior year, he was easily one of the best players on the team, but he'd be the first to tell you it was a family connection at Western Kentucky that allowed him to go there. Cameron McGrone, I think, was a fairly highly rated recruit, and he went
and
to...
And I know Michigan's gotten some players out of, like, Warren and Beattie that were really good players.
He went to Michigan. It's not like he went to, you know, Texas A&M Commerce, but...
The Lions, as we've come to know.
The Lions, yes, thank you for that. So, nice little Indy connection here again. You don't typically see a lot of these moves. The Colts have made a couple of them late in the year. I tend to think it's got more to do with kind of next season than it does, oh, you're in a dire injury situation right now. I did find it interesting. Yesterday we brought up, it was typically Tuesday, you hear from the Colts coordinators, Parks Frazier, the OC, for what it's worth. And again, Jeff Saturday will confirm it later today. But he said that he is game planning as if Matt Ryan will remain the starting quarterback. One of the coordinators mentioned a player on the team that he would call the best leader the Colts have. Any guesses?
One of the coordinators referenced a guy that they listed as the best. So you're not saying which side of the ball, right?
No, and was adamant that this person was the best leader the Colts have.
Let me ask two yes-no questions, if I may. The first being... Is this someone who is a regular starter?
Yes. Yeah.
Secondly, has this person appeared on this radio program?
Yes.
I'm going to go with Zaire Franklin.
That was my guess, too.
Boom. Obviously became a full-time starter this year. The Leonard injury situation playing into that. What Bubba Ventrone was saying was basically his mental, physical toughness sets him aside. Like, this dude... does not sit... I mean, he's a vocal leader, yes, but in the way he carries himself, and I think back to his Syracuse days, Jake, remember, he was the first three-time captain at Syracuse in like 100 years. Syracuse has got some football history, and he obviously was thought of in very high regard there, and I think has emerged this season. So, as we said a little bit earlier, again, Pro Bowl teams announced tonight. I'm not expecting Zaire Franklin to be a Pro Bowler. I think he deserves consideration for it in a season that a lot of Colts fans will want to forget. Kudos to Zaire Franklin. Signed a big contract extension for him. 3-year extension back in January. Was really just a special teamer throughout his first 4 years in the NFL. And I think he's proven he can be a definite starter in this league and is one of the league's top tacklers.
Here's a legit question for our audience. Maybe I should do this as a Twitter poll. Are you ready, Kevin?
Yeah, uh-huh.
Today is December today's Festivus, right? Isn't it Festivus, Mark?
I thought that was later in the week. Yeah. Is it the 21st? Is today the first day of winter?
It is that as well, right?
So, yeah, you're a little early. Festivus is the 23rd.
Oh, it is. Okay. My apologies. But here we are in late December with, you know, we are through turn four on the NFL season. And the Colts are, what, 4-9-1? Does anybody care who starts at quarterback?
I hate the tie, by the way.
I know. I was really hoping for 4-8-2, though. That would have been awesome. Does anybody care? I mean, we're sitting here talking about it. Do people truly care who starts at quarterback?
I think there are some. Again, if you look at next season, if Matt Ryan were to get hurt, that is a significant financial hit for your team. That will impact your decision-making next year.
I mean, I get it, but most people are like, hey, I'm not the one writing the check.
On the free agency front, but it impacts your salary cap.
Understood.
More to do with, it's not like Jim Irsay just handing him that money.
No, I get it.
So I think that's where it impacts it.
Do you think that I get why we discuss it. Do you think the average person, though, I'm saying it somewhat flippantly, but don't you think there are a lot of people that are like, you know what, at this point, who cares, man?
Without doubt.
Start Foles, yeah, whatever, who cares?
I mean, are there 95% of the fan base just wants to lose.
Right. Are there really people that are like, oh, man, so-and-so, you know, I really like the way that he can read a such-and-such on the defense.
I think if I had a ticket to Monday night, Jake, I'd rather see Sam Ehlinger than Matt Ryan.
And if you have a ticket to Monday night and you're not going to the game, you can send it to me on email, jake@1075thefan.com, and we will forward that to the United Way, where a child who normally would not be able to go to an NFL game will be able to go with a mentor to take them to the game for either of the
Colts. I was
going to
say, not only Monday night, but January 8th, correct, the season finale against Houston, correct, which, yeah.
And thank you to those that did so yesterday.
Stephen Holder's going to join us next. Stephen had an interesting tweet yesterday about Jim Irsay's comments recently about looking at some less obvious coaching candidates. We'll get Steven's thoughts on that here. 8 o'clock hour, Kevin and Querry, and what looks to be a start of a sunny Wednesday here in Indy.
The calendar gets confusing this time of year. Now we have Saturday on Monday. It's the Colts and Chargers from Lucas Oil Stadium. Monday night. Pre-game at 5:30. Matt Taylor has the kickoff at 8:15 on 97.1 Hank FM.
97.1 Hank FM is Indy's number one for new country.
I need something new, bro. Trying to catch a good time.
Game day starting an hour before kickoff on your home for Colts football. 97.1 Hank FM.
Guys, solve your ED today with an intimacy guarantee only at the Indianapolis Men's Clinic. If you don't perform, you don't pay. Call the Indianapolis Men's Clinic at 999-9000. 999-9000.
The Michael Lewis era of Ball State basketball has arrived. Get to Muncie December 21st as the Cards host Georgia Southern at 7 p.m. Get tickets at ballstatesports.com or charge by phone 888-BSU-TICKET. Ask about the Ball and Brew Pack.
Hey there, it's Jake Query for the Good Feet Store of Indiana. Good Feet Store of Indiana, two locations, one in Greenwood and one at 82nd and Dean in the Clearwater Shops. Chris is the general manager, kind of goes back and forth between stores. Jake, that's great. I hear you talking about the Good Feet Store. What exactly are you talking about? Well, let me tell you. Thank you for asking. The Good Feet Store is where you can get the custom arch supports to go inside your shoes, interchangeably one pair of shoes to the next to allow for a balance of your feet. And I had plantar fasciitis at one point. I remember before the mini marathon, I came in here. I'm like, guys, I think I dislocated my ankle. It all came from an inflammation of the tendons in the bottom of my feet. Then I found out about the Good Feet Store. Went in, no hassle, no obligation, simply walked in, or limped in my case. And they did a simple scan or an imprint of my foot, found out where the pressure points were, and got me the arch supports that are designed to the contour of my foot, not a one-size-fits-all type deal. And ever since then, that personalized experience has paid off for me in being pain-free when it comes to my feet, with a 100% guarantee. And in addition to that, an all-American made product. A lot to love about the Good Feet Store. Again, free fitting and test walk, no appointment necessary. Give them a look in Greenwood or at 82nd and Dean in the Clearwater Shops. That's goodfeetindy.com.
Hi guys, it's Mark. Are you struggling with erectile dysfunction? Did you know that a major medical breakthrough is now available and it isn't a pill? Today, Wednesday, December 21st, we're running a one-day special you won't want to miss out on. Pine Grove Medical Clinic uses the most powerful form of wave therapy. This is a technology clinically shown to repair blood vessels and improve blood flow. It's backed by 60 clinical studies, including from Cambridge. If you're ready to regain the spark in your bedroom, today is your day. Call us now and you'll qualify for the assessment and ultrasound totally free. You'll also get a gift that can produce rapid and powerful results in the bedroom in minutes. You're going to love that one, guys. Trust me. And today only, we're offering 6 tune-up treatments to our patients free. This is an unprecedented offer worth hundreds of dollars, but call today and qualify totally free. Call 317-552-1111. That's 317-552-1111. Guys, put a stop to your erectile dysfunction and get your life back. Call Pine Grove Medical Clinic now to qualify. This offer ends today, Wednesday. 317-552-1111.
Make some midweek magic with Light the Lamp, Wednesdays at BetMGM, an official sports betting partner of the NHL. Place a $25 wager on any NHL player to score a goal on Wednesday, and you'll automatically receive $2 in free bets for every goal scored in the game, up to $16 in free bets. Just log into your account or download the app and sign up with BetMGM to get started. Then opt in to the Light the Lamp Wednesdays promotion to receive a $2 free bet for every goal scored in the game, regardless of your prop bet's outcome. Take your shot every Wednesday at BetMGM. Visit BetMGM.com for terms and conditions. 21 years of age or older to wager, Indiana only. A new and existing customer offer. All promotions are subject to qualification and eligibility requirements. Rewards issued as non-withdrawable free bets or site credit. Free bets expire 7 days from issuance. If you or somebody you know has a gambling problem and wants help, call 1-800-9-WITH-IT.
Are you still looking for the perfect holiday gift? You know what I'm talking about. The one that gets passed around the room and you hear a lot of oohs and ahs? Then come to Shane Company. We put so much love and care into the fine jewelry we create. Our classic styles are true treasures. With our expertise and attention to detail, they can be handed down to the next generation and look as beautiful as the day you bought them. They're a great investment. We have diamond tennis bracelets, classic solitaire pendants, and styles with cultured pearls. Our diamond stud earrings make a wonderful holiday gift because they'll never lose that amazing sparkle. We have a wide range of shapes and carat weights to choose from, so it'll be easy to find studs in your price range. We also offer studs in a variety of colorful gemstones. And with Shane Company's generous upgrade policy, you can upgrade your studs at any time. Visit us in-store or shop online and enjoy free 2-day shipping. It's never too late to give a gift they'll treasure forever.
Now you have a friend in the jewelry business. Shane Company and ShaneCo.com.
Christmas cheer is in short supply for our neighbors who are hungry, homeless, hurting. Today you can give them meals, shelter, and care with a gift to Wheeler Mission. You'll also provide addiction recovery, life skills, job training, and other vital care that transforms lives. Your gift is needed right now as hundreds of hurting people are turning to Wheeler Mission for help every day. Share Christmas cheer. Donate now at WheelerMission.org. That's WheelerMission.org.
93.5 and 107.5, The Fan.
WIBC HD2, W298BB, WIBC HD3, W228CX, Indianapolis.
The Colts host the Los Angeles Chargers on Monday Night Football. The coverage starts at 5:30 on The Fan and 97.1 Hank FM.
Kevin and Query on 93.5 and 107.5, The Fan.
8 o'clock hour in Indianapolis. Technically speaking, it is the 8 o'clock hour everywhere in the Eastern time zone. My name is Jake Query. Kevin Bowen here as well. Mark Dykton flying the Millennium Falcon for us. Joining us now on the Payless Liquors hotline. And by the way, this is Kevin and Query on 93.5, 107.5, The Fan. He is a regular guest of this program on Wednesdays. You read his work, of course, with ESPN. Stephen Holder joins us to talk about the Indianapolis Colts. And Stephen, I'll begin with this. I was asking Kevin this kind of rhetorically, but I want you to weigh in. I realize that the Colts can say, you know, they're still trying to win games, or Jeff Saturday's doing what he can to put them in the best position, etc. But their moves over the last week, to me, appear to be a franchise that know it's over. You agree or disagree?
I will say this. I don't hear a whole lot of, you know, the usual, you know, sayings that you hear when a team is trying to convince itself that these games matter. Like, you know, well, we're not eliminated just yet. And they're not, right? They're not eliminated from the playoffs, which says more about the AFC South than them, but whatever. No one has said anything to me about the playoffs in a very long time. Not that I want to hear it, okay? Granted. But I haven't heard that. Normally, until the day you're mathematically eliminated, you still hear that, you know, that conversation. I would also say, you know, just in terms of them talking about, you know, having a lot to play for, and I've heard things like, you know, you've got personal pride. I think it was Matt Ryan who even said that last week. You know, he says, you know, you've got a lot of personal pride to play for. Oh, well, that's a team that is telling you this is not going anywhere. So, yeah, I mean, even though they're not eliminated, I think the way things have felt the last two games in particular, to me, I think it just kind of leaves you with a taste in your mouth that, like, you're just waiting for this thing to be over.
Can Stephen Holder with us from ESPN.com. Stephen, I want to go to a tweet you had yesterday and referencing some Jim Irsay comments over the past few weeks about a willingness, I guess, to look at some less obvious coaching candidates. I believe he particularly mentioned college candidates. You know, honestly, before Luke Fickell went to Wisconsin, that was maybe the name that I would have had very high on a list. You know, I think you know this pretty well. I mean, Chris Ballard, extremely fond of what Fickell did at Cincinnati. For what it's worth, I know it was probably 20-some years ago, but the college roommate of Luke Fickell was Mike Vrabel. So if you're looking for a connection there, you got a little bit of it. I believe they did coach together at one point. But I guess, what did you make of those Irsay comments, and did any names pop into your head when you saw that?
Yeah, I mean, I mentioned it because, you know, it was something that he said to me quite a few weeks ago in a conversation about something else, and it kind of veered, as conversations tend to do with Jim Irsay, it veered into other topics. And I think, you know, he was kind of, I think, making the point, I don't know if he was trying to solidify or reinforce his choice of Jeff Saturday or not, but, you know, that was certainly a very unconventional choice. And I think it was almost kind of doubling down on the idea that, you know, we should think outside the box a little more. Not necessarily in terms of experience, like hiring someone who's never done the job, maybe. You know, I don't think that's the argument he was making, thank God. But he was certainly saying, we kind of, or the NFL, not we, but the NFL kind of interviews the same profile of coach, right? You know, who's the up-and-coming coordinator, or who's the retread head coach, right? I mean, that's basically the profile that gets hired or gets interviewed in these hiring cycles. That's true. And so, for better or worse, his argument was, hey, you know, we should think a little bit outside the box. And I do think that Chris Ballard has some history of doing that. I mean, I didn't, obviously Matt Rhule didn't work out, but Matt Rhule was someone that he had an eye on, you know, when he was at Baylor.
Yeah, early in his Baylor days.
Yeah, exactly. And this was probably a couple years before he got the NFL job in Carolina. So, I mean, he was kind of an early to that party, you know, if you will. Again, didn't work out, but I think the idea that Jim Irsay is talking about, I think Chris Ballard may already be there on some level, you know, because I think he has some history of doing that. So anyway, he didn't name names, and that's the hard part here. So I don't know who he's talking about, and I know, but certainly the way he describes that profile of candidate, we're not talking about Jim Harbaugh here, right? You know, we're talking about, you know, I think the Luke Fickell example is a great one. Someone at that level. So Albert Breer, Sports Illustrated, replied to my tweet and threw out Matt Campbell, who is someone I hadn't thought about, but I think I like a guy like Luke Fickell a little better, but I think that's maybe the profile of person we're talking about, the Iowa State head coach, who's built a, you know, a pretty competitive program.
NFL teams have had interest in him.
Yeah, a place where they just, you know, it's really hard to sustain success, right? A program that's hard to sustain success. So anyway, it's interesting, and I think it's something to just file away in our memory banks as we move forward in this coaching search.
Stephen, do you believe that Jeff Saturday has any regret about giving this tenure a try as the head coach?
I don't think so. I really don't. I take him at his word when he says that he has had a good time and that he has enjoyed this. I mean, it's put him in position to be in a conversation about being the next coach just because he is currently the coach. And that certainly wasn't going to happen sitting on the set on ESPN. So, and the other thing for Jeff is, I mean, look, if you're his agent, I mean, you now have you have options. I mean, I think, you know, in terms of television, you know, so this hasn't been a setback for him. If anything, it's probably enhanced his career moving forward if he decides to stay in television, if this doesn't ultimately work out for him. So I don't think Jeff Saturday has lost anything here. If anything, he's gained from this. So I really don't see any reason for him to have regret. I think this is, even though it hasn't, you know, losing is not fun, clearly, but in the grand scheme, I don't think Jeff Saturday is losing anything here. I think he has gained from this, and he'll personally, I don't say profit, but, you know, it's not about money per se, but I think, you know, personally, he will gain from this, I think.
And he probably did make some pretty good money here for this 2 months stint as well. Stephen Holder with us from ESPN.com. Stephen, I want to go back to, I believe you guys had it first on ESPN.com over the weekend. Basically, the NFL sending a memo out to owners, reminding them of how much money they have spent on firing head coaches and GMs. Part of me read it was like, well, it's kind of their money. They can do with it whatever they want. Having said that, Frank Reich was mentioned in the story. 4 years left on his contract, $9 million annually. Do you think, I guess, I don't think Jim Irsay loses sleep over the finances of that and would lose the sleep over the finances of firing Chris Ballard on top of that if you were to do it with Ballard under contract for the same length of time as Reich was. But I do think he could lose sleep over the ego of having to fire or deciding to fire both, you know, 16 months after giving them both an extension. Do you think that would be at play at all with Irsay a little bit more? Am I willing to do this, admit that I was wrong, versus the actual finances of, you know, paying two guys a large sum of money, granted a sum of money that he has?
Right. So I'll start by saying I actually think the money, I'm not saying it's hurting him necessarily, but let me just say he is very, very, very aware of the amount of money. Okay, and I know that from personal conversations.
And like how it looks or?
No, just the dollar amount. Okay. Like I will tell you, we had a conversation about this, about Frank Reich. And one of the things that he said is that, look, you know, I think he said something like, you know, when this is over, I'll have committed north of $50 million to Frank Reich. He's like, that is a significant commitment. And I thought at first I was like, all right, he's just talking out of his rear end here. You know, I literally didn't use the number because I didn't believe it. I wasn't sure he was accurate because he does do that sometimes, right? You kind of throw things out and you're like, all right, there's no way that's true. And maybe it is true now in retrospect, looking back at it. I was like, I didn't think Frank was making that much. I was like, whoa, okay. So anyway, my point is he was very, very aware and emphasized that dollar amount multiple times. So I think it matters to him in terms of just the money. Then to your point about, you know, the optics of it, I think that matters too. I mean, you know, especially with Chris Ballard, where you have said, he has said some things about Chris Ballard, you know, that are hard to just, you know, take back. I mean, yeah. You called him basically the greatest talent evaluator in NFL history.
Michael Jordan missed shots. Michael Jordan lost games.
Exactly. You've called him the GOAT, you know, just recently. So, and has since doubled down on his intention to keep him. I think he told that to Zach Kiefer recently. So, I actually buy that Chris Ballard is going to be back. I think the question is going to be, you know, how much of the critical decision-making is going to fall to Chris Ballard? That is the question, because every critical decision since the end of the 2021 season has basically been made by Jim Irsay. The Carson Wentz decision, the Matt Ryan benching, Frank Reich being fired, and the Jeff Saturday hire, those were all decisions that were driven by Jim Irsay and Jim Irsay alone. So, or primarily, put it that way. So that's the question for me. And how does that play with Chris Ballard and moving forward? And then the other question related to this is whoever they hire, all right, if that's, you know, is that going to be a quote-unquote strong head coach, someone who wants, authority over the roster and things like that? So there's a lot still to be determined that I think impacts how Chris Ballard operates moving forward and whether this is somewhere he wants to be.
Stephen, do you believe, Stephen Holder is our guest, do you believe that the value that is perceived that Chris Ballard has, I'm not saying he doesn't, but his perceived value, is it higher within the Colts organization than it is league-wide? Or do you believe that he still has perceived value among other franchises? And I've got a follow-up, which is why I'm asking it.
That's a good question. I actually think he still has a lot of value league-wide, a lot of credibility. Okay.
And the reason why, and I know I cut you off there, but the reason why I ask that, because that answers the first part of it. So the second part is this. If there is value of Chris Ballard outside of Indianapolis, do we know for certain, if he has options, that this is where he wants to be? Because the last times that I have seen him publicly around other members of the organization with which he works, he looked like he wanted to be anywhere but there. So we're making so much of, do the Colts want Chris Ballard back? Is it also time for us to ask, does Chris Ballard want to be back?
I mean, look, I have actually wondered this as well. I think it's a little more tricky than I think just saying, hey, does he want to be here or not, right? I mean, it's not like, you know, if the average person wants to move on from where they work, they find another job, they move on, right? Obviously, the NFL, it's a little more difficult if you're in one of those jobs that is basically one of 32, right? So Chris Ballard's one of 32. Is there another job open for a team that wants him? And is that a job that he wants? Is that, you know, what are the financials of that? You know, does he take a pay cut? All these things, right? So, I mean, it's not quite that simple, but I think the overarching question is fair. And it is something I have wondered. And the reason I say he still has value outside, and certainly he has been knocked down a notch, right? I mean, the team is in shambles. So that's certainly been knocked down a notch. But I think his draft results, even though there have been some big questions that fans locally would ask, right? But the draft results, I mean, Chris Ballard has a fantastic eye for talent. That is still true. But I think what's gotten him in trouble is the quarterback situation, and certainly the Josh McDaniels thing is always going to be sort of a stain on his record as well. But overall, the draft results, which are, you know, probably like 50% of the job, right? Acquiring talent, he's done a really good job at that. But there are some really big issues that I think he'd have to explain.
Again, Stephen Holder is with us from ESPN.com. Colts get back to practice today. They're going to have a normal practice schedule this week, take the weekend off for Christmas, and then play Monday Night Football against the Chargers. Stephen, I know it's not, at least when, you know, I'm a radio guest, it's not the question that I love the most, but I'm going to throw it at you anyways because I think you can handle it. If you're going to look at the big three in the organization right now, and that would be the general manager, Ballard, the head coach, Jeff Saturday, and the quarterback, Matt Ryan, if you don't mind, you throw percentages on each of those three having the same roles they have right now in 2023. Start with Ballard, go to Saturday, and then Ryan.
Yeah. So Chris Ballard, GM, I think about 70%, I'd say, right now. The only reason it's not higher is because, you know, Jim Irsay is, you know,
Jim Irsay.
Right now he's a little unpredictable, right? So that's one. Jeff Saturday, I think it's low. I think we're talking like 20%, and I would go lower if it wasn't just for just the love that Jim Irsay has for him that may cloud, you know, his decision making there. But I don't think it's very high. And then Matt Ryan, I think you want to say there's no chance, right? But the financials do come into play. If he's back at all, it's because they have a young quarterback and he's grooming him and what have you. In the same role, meaning like the guy throughout the season, I just don't think that's likely at all. There's like a 5% chance of that.
They need him to retire. I mean, I know there's plenty of financial reasons for him not to retire, but.
Right, if you're him, you're going to sit and wait and let them make the move.
Yeah.
Because if I'm him, I want my money. Okay, that's the bottom line. I want my $12 million. Sure. I think at minimum it'd be $12 million. But I think in the grand scheme, yes, I think you're right. I think Matt Ryan, I think it's in everybody's best interest if they give him his $12 million and he goes home and he says, thanks for the memories, guys. I'm out.
Stephen Holder's our guest, ESPN.com, where you can read his work covering the Colts. Stephen, it's Christmas time, right? And we've been sitting here going over the naughty list for the last 15 minutes. So let's go to the nice list real quick. And by that, I want you to give me two names. One being a player that has really done a nice job in taking advantage of a season of suck by saying, you know what, here's what I can do, and opening eyes to the Colts organization of, hey, you know what, we have somebody here and we didn't think we did. And then secondly, the guy right now that headed down the home stretch has a really golden opportunity to show that he belongs on this franchise and to cement himself as an NFL player.
Okay, so great question. The first one, I think, is Zaire Franklin. This guy, let me tell you, I think he's, fifth in the NFL in tackles or something like that right now. Zaire Franklin has always been established on special teams. We know he's very good there. But to take advantage of the opportunity he had this year, I looked this up. I don't think he's ever played more than something like 15% of the defensive snaps in a given season. He has played 100% of the snaps this year, you know, just about 100% of the defensive snaps. And he has taken great advantage of it. And I think in the last few games, you're starting to see him try to create turnovers as well. You know, I think he's taken some lessons from Shaquille Leonard. You know, we saw him punch a ball out the other day. And from a leadership standpoint, I mean, that was never going to be a question, right? He's a phenomenal leader. A lot of credit to him, you know, for just making the best of it and always having perspective too, win or lose. And then remind me again, the second category, what were you talking about?
A guy that is on his way to the complex right now and is saying to himself, you know, I don't want people to think that I'm enjoying the fact that we're not very good, but I got a real opportunity here, and I'm really optimistic heading down the home stretch because this is my chance. This is my shot, and I'm excited about it.
So there's a guy that someone was talking to me about this week, someone in the organization, who he was mentioned again yesterday by defensive coordinator Gus Bradley. It's Dallas Flowers, their young corner. You know, we saw him get involved in special teams a couple of weeks ago, and I was kind of like, well, who the hell is number 33? I had to look him up. And as it turns out, I mean, he had to play on defense the other day, and they're suddenly very excited about his potential. And I think as they get further and further away from playing for anything here, you know, maybe that's a guy or maybe one of other guys as well who get some playing time so they can look at them and evaluate them, you know, for next year and beyond. I mean, that's where they're at this point, right? I mean, you're at this point trying to figure out what you have and what you can do moving forward with your roster. So that makes sense to me. So he's a guy to watch, apparently.
Yeah, no need to play Brandon Faison anymore. Play Dallas Flowers, play Isaiah Rodgers. Down the stretch.
Who was on Dallas Flowers?
Hey, Pittsburgh State Gorilla, Jake Query over there. Okay. Stephen, we'll end with this. Pro Bowl teams announced tonight.
Oh, yeah.
Do the Colts get one?
I mean, I think they have some Pro Bowl-level players. Whether they make it and whether the stain of playing for the Colts overrides that, I don't know. I'll be curious to see whether DeForest Buckner makes it. I think he...
A lot of good D tackles in the AFC.
That's the problem, right? It becomes a numbers game at that position. Same with Stephon Gilmore. Do I think he's played at a Pro Bowl level? I do. But, you know, that it becomes a little bit of a popularity contest, and I don't know. I think those are the two strongest candidates, I think. I mean, Zaire Franklin is a candidate, frankly, but I...
He doesn't have the name.
Yeah, that's what I was going to say. Oftentimes with the Pro Bowl, it takes you a couple of years of having an established name, unless you're just a fantasy football darling and everybody knows you, you know?
See, that's why I think Nelson's still in the mix, just because players and coaches are just going to write his name down.
That's fair. And he still is. Look, he's still a tough assignment for people, even though he's not playing at the level we are accustomed to. So, yeah, I think those are probably the three strongest candidates, unless I'm forgetting someone. But yeah, it will not be like last year when I think, what did they have? 7, I believe.
Yep.
It won't be 7. I can tell you that.
Well, Stephen Holder has already done his penance for this holiday season and going to multiple Pacer games with Jake Query. So hope that the holiday season treats you well, Stephen.
Stephen, have you ever enjoyed an NBA game with a greater amount of conspiracy theory out of left field and 70s rock music references than you have with the Doors that I've introduced for you in that?
No, I will tell you, it's basically like a 3-hour version of this five, you know, 15-minute appearance. I'm
just picturing him.
Bad, I don't know.
I'm picturing him leaning over to you for the umpteenth time and saying, "All right, you might think I'm really crazy, but
this is true."
Why would you think that?
Yeah. Okay. Here come the power pack. You might think this is really crazy, but I've heard this about the power pack. So, yeah, Stephen, happy holidays, man. You'll probably just be here, but safe travels to New York coming up around the new year, and I always appreciate the time.
All right, guys. Hey, thankfully they're good seats with Jake, so that makes up for it.
Yeah, he can thank the significant other for that one.
That's true.
Thanks, Stephen.
Sam Fritz that said to Shannon, you know, you ought to stick by him because he's got access to seats like this. She's like, au contraire, brother.
Oh, man.
So are you saying that I'm now, that I've inherited as the greatest conspiracy theorist on this radio station?
That might go for all of our stations.
Well.
What are you saying, bees, Christmas music? Mark falls in the conspiracy theory front? One name I did want to throw out there. Again, we referenced with Steven a little bit earlier in that conversation. The less obvious coaching candidate names. Quarterbacks coach for the Philadelphia Eagles is Brian Johnson. What he's done with Jalen Hurts, pretty darn impressive. Also worked with Dak Prescott at Mississippi State. Again, if you are an owner and you're kind of infatuated with the let's pair the young offensive mind with that quarterback draft selection, I think he would be a name. It's probably too big of a jump to go from quarterback's coach to head coach, but if you want to think a little outside the box, I think he's a name that would fit that mold.
I'm still going to maintain. I still think Leslie Frazier will get a hard look. Like, I just,
you think he's too similar to Frank Reich with temperament?
I totally agree, Kev. I just keep hearing his name. I'm not saying that's who I would go after, but I've heard his name from the get-go, and it just seems, you know, he's the one that just has kind of been around the whole time. You know what I mean?
Yeah, obviously from Dungy to Caldwell, the temperament was the same. You didn't want to fire Dungy. You wanted to maintain the success that you were having. But if you look from Caldwell to Pagano, Pagano to McDaniels, frankly, McDaniels to Reich, and now even Reich to Saturday, those are all 180s in terms of personalities.
Fair.
And I think you see that in any hire, and probably goes for any profession. So, but to your point, Jake, Leslie Frazier's a guy that tons of organizational ties. If Jeff Saturday is still involved in some way, shape, or form, you know, he was on the staff here when they won the Super Bowl when Saturday was playing, of course, and he interviewed that second time around. Dan Campbell, Frank Reich, and Leslie Frazier. Those were the three final candidates after McDaniels left the Colts at the altar.
When I was a kid and first started watching the NFL, the two dominant teams that were, and it felt like a different era, that you didn't have the parity that you have now. So, like, there were two dominant teams, and it was the Dallas Cowboys and the Pittsburgh Steelers. And I've told you guys a million times, kids my age that grew up in markets that didn't have the NFL, like Indianapolis was at that time, most kids were fans of either the Pittsburgh Steelers or the Dallas Cowboys. And So Steelers-Cowboys has always kind of been ingrained in my mind of like the NFL rivalry. Just, and that is 100% age bias. But then you get a guy named Dallas that played at Pittsburgh State, and it's like, well, this guy's a can't miss. So it was obvious that Dallas Flowers was going to be a great player, because when you combine Dallas and Pittsburgh, in your mind, you think NFL through and through. Also thinking of that time period of the late 70s and the great Steelers teams, that does lead us to sad news this morning that we learned about an hour and a half ago, and that leads off our morning checkdown.
The Morning Checkdown, brought to you by Ball State Basketball. Get your tickets at ballstatesports.com on 93.5 and 107.5 The Fan.
Four Super Bowls for Franco Harris, including the Super Bowl MVP and Super Bowl IX. The 1972 Immaculate Reception will celebrate its 50-year anniversary upcoming this weekend. Franco Harris ran for over 12,000 yards in the NFL and is responsible for what has been deemed the most famous play in the history of the game against the Oakland Raiders when he caught the pass that was intended for Frenchie Fuqua and intercepted, or I should say deflected, by Jack Tatum. Franco Harris passing away at the age of 72. His son making that announcement that came out just before we went on the air this morning. So
just so eerie, Jake, with the 50th year anniversary. So many celebrations in Pittsburgh coming up this weekend. Again, it's Raiders Steelers Saturday night in Pittsburgh. That's the Christmas Eve solo game, and we have not heard any cause of death. Correct? You just said his son just correct. Mentioned he passed overnight at the age of 72.
No cause of death, although I don't believe he had been ill. I guess it's unfair to speculate. I mean, certainly at that age, you think to yourself, well, he must have had a heart attack. I don't know. I don't know that anybody knows. But, you know, Franco Harris really was a guy that was the, and we'll talk to Mike DeCourcy about this, among other things, who's a big Steelers fan. But Franco Harris, as much as any player that you could think of the great NFL players, absolutely embodied just kind of the spirit and the tenor of the city in which he played. I mean, you know, he was a blue collar between like lunch pail kind of guy, between the tackles kind of guy, and a great player, absolutely a great player. And, you know, he kind of rubbed people the wrong way during some of the Jerry Sandusky, Joe Paterno stuff in his defense of Penn State. But overall, seemingly a good citizen and a great player, unquestionably. So sad news this morning.
It's going to be pretty somber. It was going to be a celebratory.
It is surprising that his number was not already retired by the Pittsburgh Steelers.
Yeah, I don't know how Pittsburgh handles that stuff, but yeah, that was surprising me when I saw that.
Unless I read this wrong, they said it was only going to be the third jersey retirement in franchise history.
Okay.
I was going to say, they strike me as a franchise that, I mean, don't the Cowboys not retire any jerseys?
Yeah, I mean, the Steelers would have, I mean, hell, you'd be out of numbers after a while.
Yeah, I got two 44s playing on each side of the ball right now.
Yeah, the Cowboys 88 is always like, who's wearing 88? That's the big deal.
Last night in Bloomington, Indiana 96, Elon 72. No Trace Jackson Davis. He was out for precautionary reasons. I think been dealing with a bit of a back problem. I know Xavier Johnson, of course, riding around on a scooter, big boot on that injured foot of his, and no Jordan Geronimo. Race Thompson had 18, Jalen Hood-Schifino 17. He had 7 assists, but 5 turnovers. So the point guard question with no update on Xavier Johnson, but likely to miss more time. That will be looming for Indiana the rest of the year. They just don't have like a natural backup point guard to turn to. I think Hood-Schifino ideally would be a little bit more off the ball. So this is going to be a major question for Mike Woodson's bunch. They've got Kennesaw State. I think that's Friday, and that's it until they face Iowa on January 5th.
In the association, Pacers in action tonight, taking on the Boston Celtics. Celts come in at 22-9. Indiana game under 500 at 15-16. That game tips off at 7:30. And, of course, you can hear it right here on this radio station with Mark Boyle on the call, pregame beginning at 7 p.m.
10-point underdog tonight for the Pacers.
You're worried about that 30. They're halfway there.
I'm starting to sweat a little bit. It's Christmas season.
I'm starting to sweat a little bit. 900 degrees in here.
Tonight, Purdue has got New Orleans. They're back inside of Mackey Arena. They are a big, big favorite in that one. 33.5 is the Boilermakers return home as the still number one team in college basketball. And briefly looking ahead to Thursday night football tomorrow night, it's the Jags at the Jets in the battle of number one versus number two, right? Zach Wilson going to start? for the Jets?
I think he is, right?
So the number one overall pick, of course, Trevor Lawrence from last year. Zach Wilson, the number two overall pick. And Mark, you pointed out very accurately, this is the marquee primetime game we have in Week 16.
Who would have guessed that heading into Christmas? Jaguars-Jets, the best primetime game of the weekend slate.
And if the Jags win, the Colts are officially eliminated from the postseason.
The Jags and the Jets. That sounds like a West Side Story.
I mean, with a nice more, tint of green throughout, right?
Yeah, more than an NFL matchup, right?
I don't know if Trevor Lawrence has the look of a West Side Story character.
Oh, he's got that long hair, let me tell you.
Can he snap his fingers?
Do a little dance through the streets?
Uh-huh. Yeah. Who's that guy over there, Tommy? It's one of them Jets. You don't like them.
That's right.
That was well done, Mark. Mike DeCourcy is going to join us, talk some college basketball at the top of the hour. Kevin and Corey on a gorgeous start this Wednesday here in Indy.
Crew Car Wash books make the perfect holiday gift, and right now buy four Ultimate Washes and get two free, available online or at any Crew Car Wash location.
It's the Colts VIP tailgate presented by Hayes & Sons Restoration. Make your game day experience the best it can be. Log on and get your tickets now. It's BullseyeEventGroup.com.
If you have ever thought about remodeling your bathroom but were worried it would take too long or cost too much, then stop worrying. Right now, Jacuzzi Bath Remodel has designed a collection of high-quality custom products and perfected the one-day remodeling experience so you can enjoy your new bathroom faster than ever before. It's a worry-free bath remodel from the most trusted brand name in the business, Jacuzzi. A Jacuzzi Bath system fits in your existing tub space. It's a no-mess installation with an amazing style selection, factory-certified installers, and a limited lifetime warranty. Call 800-717-4599. That's 800-717-4599 right now and get 50% off installation with no interest and no payments for 12 months. Replace that old bathtub today with a walk-in shower for a safer bathing experience. If you have lived in your home for over 15 years, it's time to remodel your bathroom. For a virtual or in-home appointment, call 800-717-4599. That's 800-717-4599. 800-717-4599.
Jake Query here for the DraftKings Sportsbook app, which is my go-to when betting on the NBA this holiday season. I love the NBA during the holidays, and what better way to accentuate that fun than same-game wagers on any of the NBA games, and for you Pacer fans, a no-sweat bet on every Pacer game this December. That's right. This month, everyone can earn a no-sweat bet with the DraftKings Sportsbook app. Head to the DraftKings Sportsbook app, opt in under the Promos tab, and place an eligible bet of your choice on a Pacer game, and even if it doesn't hit, you're going to get your money back in a free bet. With payouts bigger than ever, DraftKings Sportsbook app is where to go to bet on the NBA. Download the DraftKings Sportsbook app now. New customers can sign up with a promo code 1075FAN and get a no-sweat bet on every Pacer game this December. Go to the DraftKings Sportsbook app and opt in today to receive this limited-time offer only at DraftKings Sportsbook, an official sports betting partner of the Indiana Pacers. Must be 21 or older, Indiana only. Max reward limits apply. One free bet issued based on amount of initial losing bet. Eligibility restrictions apply. See terms at sportsbook.draftkings.com/basketball terms. If you have a gambling problem, call 1-800-9-WITH-IT.
Ladies and gentlemen, please. 40, love, match point.
Out. There's no way that was out.
Out. The ball is out. It's out.
Are you even watching?
No, honestly, I'm not. I'm watching college football on my phone with AT&T 5G.
Wow. That's too much.
With AT&T 5G, too much college football is never too much. 5G requires compatible plan and device. 5G may not be available in your area. See att.com/5G for you for details.
Here's Howie Long for Skechers Hands-Free Slip-In Footwear.
The world has gone hands-free. However, if you want to put on a pair of sneakers, you still need to bend down and help your feet in. Until now. Introducing Skechers Hands-Free Slip-In Footwear. You don't need to reach down to help your heel in. You just step into them and off you go. So what's the secret? Well, there's a special smooth comfort pillow in the heel that helps your foot slide into place. And they stay on just like a pair of laced-up sneakers.
Get hands-free slip-ins at a Skechers store, Skechers.com, or wherever stylish footwear is sold.
The Ride with JMV.
Matt Painter with us. You guys this week voted number one in the nation. And I know that was that way a year ago. What do you tell your guys in a situation like this?
Well, that's what one of our guys talked about when we found out yesterday at the end of practice. You know, he talked about how short-lived it was. You know, there's no doubt there's a burden there. Tom Izzo texted me the other day and said, you know, it's definitely a burden, but it's a good burden.
The Ride with JMV.
Weekdays 3 to 6.
On 93.5 and 107.5. The Fan.
Ooh, Merry Christmas.
comes this time each year.
You're listening to Kevin and Querry on 93.5 and 107.5, The Fan.
By the way, little insider tip behind the scenes of the way things happen here during the break. Kevin Bowen's been consistent.
A lot of sausage made, right? Do we have the Irsay quote?
Speaking of that, Mark, when it comes to making sausage, what we do.
I don't know how to make sausage. I don't know what goes into sausage.
By the way, we did breakfast for dinner last night at the Bowen household.
Oh, that's always fun. Yeah. Pancakes?
It was a good twist. Yeah, sausage, bacon, eggs. Rosie was very happy.
I used to love that when I was a kid. Kevin Bowen, in the commercial break, has been consistently refreshing his computer because it's college football signing day.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And,
uh-huh.
And, you know, I mean, you've been tweeting these kids all week, right?
I just don't go tweet. I just go DM.
Sending memes?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Come here.
Yep.
Oh, yeah. This is awkward.
Hey, good luck at prom.
How about the kid from the one thing that I did see is the number one.
Actually, Notre Dame could have two Bowens in their recruiting class, by the way.
Okay. And, you know, that's of importance to three Bowens. I saw a headline about it. The number one offensive tackle in the country. He's a native of Des Moines, or Des Moines, as I like to call it. And he had verbally committed to Iowa and Kirk Ferentz. And, like, his social media thing was, like, his bio was, like, number one OT, like, Hawkeye for life. And his background picture was him where, you know, when he verbaled to Iowa, like, wearing the Iowa hat and wearing an Iowa sweatshirt. And, like, his entire Twitter timeline was black and gold. And so he, of course, because he's the number one offensive tackle in the country, he sent a thing like, I invite all media to come out for my signing day. Going to be epic. And all the Iowa-like scribes showed up, and he came out and said, you know what? I changed my mind and signed with Alabama. It's like, okay.
One of my favorite signing day stories, and I think I have this correct, but, and ironically enough, it has some relevance now that Eugene Hilton is a sophomore at Zionsville and is starting to gain some college interest. He was a young, I think like one-ish years old when his father picked a college, and it was either going to be West Virginia or Florida International. And if I'm not mistaken, put two hats on the end of the bed or the end of the table and said, Eugene, you go up there and pick it.
That's right. That is right.
FIU, baby, over West Virginia. You know one of my favorite players ever to watch? Who's on the Chargers coaching staff, and that's how I kind of popped back into my
Pat
brain.
White.
Pat White, offensive assistant for the Chargers.
You want a cookie? What do you want?
I mean, come on.
Okay. Would T.Y. Hilton been on those teams?
What are you buzzing me for? I was correct.
You want your pat on the back.
Yes. I want ego Pat check. White. I mean, come on.
You were correct. I was confused by the buzzer. I mean, I'm all for a Jake buzzer, Mark.
He's got to get his ego in check.
Yeah, certainly.
I don't have an ego.
I know. Jake Griffin sitting so close to him, I'm like, Griffin, that ego's got to be hitting you in the
side of
the face.
This is what I've always said. People tell me I have an ego, and I say all the time, with the level of greatness contained within me, the humility that also exists shows that there's no ego whatsoever, right?
Of course, yeah. No, I totally agree.
It's only natural. The signing day stuff. Speaking of egos, I just want to be the best Jake that I can be. Which I am, right?
Yeah.
The thing about signing day to me that just drives me crazy, people get so caught up and hung up on, I mean, how many players have we seen, whether you're talking about Purdue, Indiana, whatever, how many players have we seen that, like, this is the end-all, be-all? Oh, wow. Like, this is, I mean, the one guy that's doing the videos for IU, and he's smoking cigars, and he's dancing around in his pajamas, and he's 45 years old, and he's genuflecting and salivating over a 17-year-old kid that doesn't want anything to do with him. Don't be the lame, creepy guy that's hanging around trying to get autographs of 17-year-old kids. How many people wasted hours of their lives waiting in line in candy-striped pants with their gut hanging over it in the bitter cold outside of Jasper High School waiting 2.5 hours to get the autograph of Romeo Langford so that they could say that they had it when he's starting for the Maine Red Claws next year? Get a life and just let things organically play out.
It's a very specific person you just described.
That's every one of them.
Didn't
you
go
not
to New Albany?
Videos? Yeah, but when he was
and
playing...
And isn't he starting to play a little better for the Spurs?
Okay, so he's averaging 11 points a game for a team that's going to win 11 games over the next 2 years. Congratulations.
Sounds like T.Y. Hilton will make his Cowboys debut this weekend. Ed Werder had yesterday that the Hilton family's flown down to Dallas. Cowboys-Eagles coming up this weekend. We'll see about Jalen Hurts, by the way. Sounds like he's a bit iffy. This is just a classic Hilton quote here to Ed Warder. I can still run, so if you think you're going to come up there and play press man-to-man and not get run by, then you are crazy.
You know, I don't know if you know this or not, but when he signed with the Cowboys, he actually put out a Cowboys hat and like a Jaguars hat, and his son picked out the Dallas hat. That's how he picked the Cowboys.
Hilton did not play last week. He was inactive, but it sounds like there is a good chance he will play against the Eagles. Did you guys see how the MVP odds shifted significantly with that Jalen Hurts injury news?
I'm assuming Patrick Mahomes is...
So Hurts was the definite favorite. Mm-hmm. And then he's got throwing shoulder issue, might not play this weekend. And now all of a sudden, Mahomes is skyrocketed.
I mean, Mahomes is the safe pick. Right?
I mean, it almost has a feel to like when Carson Wentz tore his ACL at the end of that 2017 season with the Eagles. I mean, what's Philly's record? 13-1?
I believe so.
Can't we just give the MVP to Jalen Hurts?
Yeah.
I mean, does he really need to play out the final game or two of the season?
The position that he's put them in just to get to this point, that's fair.
Now, Coach of the Year, you giving it to Sirianni? You giving it to Mr. Kneecap?
Oh, I think you got to go with Sirianni, right? That's pretty impressive.
You're not going with the Fighting Dan Campbells?
I mean, but the season is 17 weeks. It's not 8, right?
I feel like a dark horse could be Shanahan with all they've been through, and they're 10-4.
That's a good point, Mark.
That's a really good.
I mean, they're on their third-string quarterback.
Maybe they're fourth. Literally, did you see that Purdy might not play, so Josh Johnson might play?
Oh, my gosh. I love it. Josh Johnson. Been everywhere.
Now, he's a singer, right?
Jack, right? We've been over this.
Have we? Is Josh Johnson the one that's played at like 37 places?
Yeah, we went through it. It took like 40 minutes to go through all his teams.
And amongst those, he played at the Cheeseburger in Paradise, actually.
Can you recall, Jake, the two quarterbacks the Colts played in that season finale back kind of end of the Pagano era? Two QBs they signed that week. They played them both in the game. One guy did the two-minute warning, the 2-minute drill.
For
the other
Colts,
guy, yeah.
Ryan Lindley and Josh Freeman?
Great call.
Is that right?
Yeah.
Come on. Where is it? Where's the buzz this time, smarty pants?
In my opinion, that sucked.
Josh Freeman played for some, team on Coney Island and... Chuck Pagano called him the Coney Island Thrasher.
I thought, actually, Josh Freeman...
He was a high draft pick, wasn't he?
Yeah, and he was a big guy, and he had a pretty good arm. I think he played at Kansas State, but apparently there were some issues off-field about him that were of concern. I thought he was a good player.
I think Ryan Lindley's doing kind of the quarterback tour and doing some training on that front. But
Ryan Lindley actually currently is sitting in a bar with Scott Tolzien trying to convince people
Scott
that
Tolzien's
started the game
on
for the Colts.
Dallas' staff. I think Mike McCarthy consulted with Tolzien and
reunited with T.Y.
Joe Philbin to get their insight into T.Y. Hilton. I'm very interested to see how T.Y. Hilton or just his usage this weekend. That game feels like it should be more in primetime, Cowboys-Eagles, is it not?
Say that one more time.
Cowboys-Eagles should be in primetime, right?
It should be. But I think just with the Christmas holiday.
4:25 on Saturday. So it's standalone Fox game.
Yeah, it'll be the Fox game of the week.
Boy, that'll be perfect. Come home from church and just...
Watching Gardner Minshew sling it around.
I'm going to watch Minshew and Dak Prescott.
I like Gardner Minshew.
Colts.
I think next year the Colts need to have a quarterback room of Gardner Minshew, Sam Ellinger, and a first-round quarterback.
No, watch. Save that. Save the tape.
Okay.
And then you could say... And you know what? Here's the thing. In this segment, I got 9 things correct. All you'll remember is that. Thank you.
You're right. I will not get the other correct answers.
Mike DeCourcy at 9, is that right?
Mm-hmm.
All right, it's Kevin McQuarrie here, 93.5, 107.5, The Fan.
It's number one for new country. I got some famous friends. Nobody plays more new country.
Until you can.
97.1, Hank FM.
Hi guys, it's Mark. Are you struggling with erectile dysfunction? Did you know that a major medical breakthrough is now available and it isn't a pill? Today, Wednesday, December 21st, we're running a one-day special you won't want to miss out on. Pine Grove Medical Clinic uses the most powerful form of wave therapy. This is a technology clinically shown to repair blood vessels and improve blood flow. It's backed by 60 clinical studies, including from Cambridge. If you're ready to regain the spark in your bedroom, today is your day. Call us now and you'll qualify for the assessment and ultrasound totally free. You'll also get a gift that that can produce rapid and powerful results in the bedroom in minutes. You're going to love that one, guys. Trust me. And today only, we're offering 6 tune-up treatments to our patients free. This is an unprecedented offer worth hundreds of dollars, but call today and qualify totally free. Call 317-552-1111. That's 317-552-1111. Guys, put a stop to your erectile dysfunction and get your life back. Call Pine Grove Medical Clinic now to qualify. This offer ends today, Wednesday. 317-552-1111.
Enjoy all your favorite sports like never before at BetMGM. Sign up using the code THEFAN, capital T, capital F, all one word, and your first wager is risk-free up to $1,000. When you register with BetMGM, you'll get instant access to a variety of parlay selection features, live betting options, player props, and daily boosted odds specials. With BetMGM at your fingertips, every game and every play matter more than ever. Sign up today and find out why nothing beats a win at the King of Sportsbooks. Download the BetMGM app today or go to BetMGM.com and again, enter that code THEFAN, all one word, and place your first wager risk-free. Visit BetMGM.com for terms and conditions. 21 years of age or older to wager. Indiana only. New customer offer. All promotions are subject to qualification and eligibility requirements. Rewards issued as non-withdrawable free bets or site credit. Free bets expire 7 days from issuance. If you or someone you know has a gambling problem and wants help, call 1-800-9-WITH-IT.
At Total Wine & More, save big on what you love this December with hundreds of deals. Get up to 35% off over 200 different wines and spirits, including Cabernet, sparkling wine, single barrel bourbon, and so much more. These savings are huge, and even better, they're on top of prices that are already the lowest in town. Deals this good don't last long, so visit Total Wine & More to find yours. Love what you find at the lowest price, only at Total Wine & More. Drink responsibly. B21.
Get in zone, AutoZone.
Welcome to AutoZone. What are you working on today? Starting trouble. No one likes that. We'll get you set up for some stronger starts. You might just need a fresh charge, and we'll take care of that free of charge.
But if it is time for a new battery, we've got replacement batteries that'll fit your needs, starting at just $79.99. You can learn more about our battery selection at AutoZone.com. That's what makes us America's number one battery destination.
Get in zone, AutoZone.
Claim based on data from the NPD Group 2021.
And now Martha Stewart for Skechers.
When I make a dish or embark on a craft project, I always use the finest, most fabulous ingredients and materials. Which is why, when it comes to footwear, I love Skechers. Because Skechers is the comfort technology company and uses the most luxurious, innovative materials and designs to make wondrously comfortable footwear with all the fits and features like Arch Fit and Skechers' world-famous air-cooled memory foam. It's exactly the way I'd make shoes.
Find Skechers at a Skechers store, Skechers.com, or wherever stylish footwear is sold.
So I switched to Boost Mobile and got this free Samsung Galaxy A23 5G phone.
Why do you think they call it the Galaxy?
Maybe because the Samsung Galaxy A23 has a huge screen, and galaxies are huge gravitationally bound systems of stars rotating around a supermassive black hole.
And the phone is free?
When you switch to Boost Mobile.
Cool. You lost me at gravitationally bound.
Switch to Boost and get a free Samsung Galaxy A23 5G phone. Boost Mobile. Unleash your power. Limited time offer while supplies last. New customers only. Excludes tax. One device offer per line. Only available on certain networks. 5G not available everywhere. Additional restrictions apply. See your local Boost Mobile store for details.
Hubler has all the top brands. Chevy, Buick, GMC, Ford, Acura, Honda, Mazda, Nissan, and more. And every new vehicle includes a 10-year, 200,000-mile warranty. Looking to sell your vehicle? We'll pay you top dollar, even if you don't buy ours. Take it from Brooke Hubler.
You can get a car anywhere, but you can only get a warranty like this at Hubler. 10 years, 200,000 miles.
Visit drivehubler.com.
Hubler.
Warranty available on new vehicles except certain models not transferable or available on leases. A copy of the warranty is available for review at the dealership.
Listen to The Ride with JMV from 3 to 6 this week, and you could win 2 tickets to New Year's Eve with Yacht Rock Review on Saturday, December 31st at the Murat Theater, and 2 tickets to see the Zach Brown Band August 6th at Ruoff Music Center.
The Pacers are in Boston to take on the powerful Celtics tonight at 7 on 93.5 and 107.5 The Fan.
Everybody's singing. All the bells are ringing out. And it's Christmas all over again.
You're listening to Kevin and Querry on 93.5 and 107.5 The Fan.
Hey, I want to reset real quick, partially for me, but I think it's good for people to know. Maybe, Mark, this is a question for you more so. Mike DeCourcy going to join us coming up about 9 here, just a couple of minutes. to talk about, obviously, college basketball, little World Cup, and Mike, a noted Pittsburgh Steelers fan, so we will likely get into the news that some of you may not have heard, that Franco Harris, the Hall of Fame running back, legendary Pittsburgh Steeler running back, passed away seemingly, I guess, overnight or this morning at the age of 72. Mark, can you recount for me, please, the schedule for this program over the course of the holidays?
So we have a show tomorrow. It's our last show of the week.
Okay.
And Ryan Walters on the show, by the
that's
way.
That's right.
Purdue head coach, 9 o'clock.
Yeah, Ryan Walters at 9 o'clock. Then we'll be off Friday. Okay. We will have a show on Monday. We will be back on Monday because the Colts and Chargers
Monday
play Monday
the 26th, the correct. Day after Christmas. Okay.
Yes. Kevin will be here Monday and Tuesday. Then Kevin's hitting the high road for a few days at the end of the week. So
now, are you going to New Buffalo?
No, we're not going to New Buffalo. My family goes to, or my in-laws go to Marco Island, just south of Naples.
Okay. Do you play polo there?
Fort Myers. Not one of your better ones.
You did that last year, right?
Correct, yep. Okay. Yeah. Annual, post-Christmas.
And that's the day after Christmas. And then what about for the new year, Mark?
Hell if I know.
We have a show
the Monday the 2nd.
Yes, Monday the 2nd.
Recapping the Colts game the day before.
But what about New Year's Day?
That's a Sunday.
You're more than welcome to come in if you're
Is it a Sunday?
It is. Yeah. Colts Giants. 1 o'clock.
I was thinking New Year's Eve was Sunday. So no, New Year's Day is Sunday.
New Year's Eve is Saturday, and then New Year's Day is
Christmas
Sunday.
Eve and New Year's Eve always pair up.
Because remember, we did it how there's no bowl games on New Year's Day because it falls on a Sunday this year, so all the NFL games.
So with the holidays, we get one day off.
Pretty much.
This
Purdue LSU is January 2nd, that bowl game.
When I become mayor, one of the things that I'm going to do is I'm going to institute in this town that no matter what, the holiday, Christmas, and I mean, it might be in Rome and everywhere else, it might be celebrated if it falls on a Sunday, but December 25th will never be on a weekend. The best day for Christmas is what, Wednesday or Thursday, do we determine?
Oh, yeah.
Probably Wednesday,
punt the whole
right?
week then, at that point.
If it's Wednesday, you do pretty much punt the week, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, Wednesday, there's no week whatsoever. I mean, to be fair, we don't really do a job.
That is very fair, yes.
So you're saying Christmas Day falling on a Wednesday is the best?
Yeah, I think so.
Or is it Christmas Eve?
No, because Christmas Day on a Wednesday means Christmas Eve's on a Tuesday, true. And the whole week's just done.
So Monday, people are sleepwalking, right? Yeah. Tuesday, if you go into work, you knock off a little early because it's Christmas Eve. Wednesday, you're off. Thursday, clearly you're off. And then at that point, yeah, might as well go ahead and punt Friday, right?
And honestly, same thing for the next week, probably.
So as mayor, can you just make, it doesn't matter what the date says.
Well,
Christmas
as mayor,
will be on a Wednesday.
Thank you for asking, Mark. As the mayor, I have really only one initiative. Mm-hmm. And that is, and for a long time, it was the blue Indy cars were all going into the White River, and they took care of that for me, and we got our parking spots back. Now it's the scooters. The scooters all in the river, gone.
I saw somebody on a scooter this morning driving down Capitol. I'm like, it's got to be chilly.
I thought we'd see Jake on a scooter when he was late that one day.
Oh, that'd be great.
I've done.
Thought he was on the side of the red line,
you know,
coming
what?
Down Meridian.
I've done the scooters, and I get it. Let's just say that I would reduce the scooter force by 80%. I'm not saying that we don't need them at all, but we do not need them. I mean, literally, these things are like zucchinis. Every time you turn around, they're growing more scooters.
If you throw all the scooters in the White River, though, your second job as mayor will be fix the White River because there's no water flowing.
Well, I understand. There are some issues there.
The fish are dying.
Not a lot of water, I feel like, in it anyways.
In the White River?
Yeah. Downtown.
Yeah.
Yeah, there's water. It's just not exactly what we
drink
call
it.
Clean.
Mike DeCourcy, we'll talk some college basketball with him coming
mercifully.
Up next.
The calendar gets confusing this time of year. Now we have Saturday on Monday. It's the Colts and Chargers from Lucas Oil Stadium. Monday night. Pre-game at 5:30. Matt Taylor has the kickoff at 8:15 on 97.1 Hank FM.
97.1 Hank FM is Indy's number one for new country.
I need something you, trying to catch a good time.
Baby,
starting an hour before kickoff on your home for Colts football. 97.1 Hank FM.
It's the Colts VIP tailgate presented by Hayes & Sons Restoration. Make your game day experience the best it can be. Log on and get your tickets now. It's BullseyeEventGroup.com.
A place for players to play and so much more. Pick up USA Fitness Noblesville, a better way to play. Pick up USAFitness.com.
You wash your hands, you brush your teeth, but what about the nose? How do you clean your nose? With Navage.
Navage uses powered suction to pull saline in one nostril, around the back of the nose, and out the other nostril, flushing out allergens, mucus, and germs. And it's why cleaning your nose, the body's air filter, is the next evolution in daily personal hygiene. People try Navage for lots of reasons. Sinusitis, colds, allergies, snoring, things that make it hard to breathe through your nose. But over time, they find that cleaning their nose makes them feel better, a lot better. Over 3 million Navage users have written more than 100,000 reviews, averaging 4.7 stars, saying, best product I've ever used, and amazing, I love my Navage. Navage helps you breathe better, sleep deeper, and snore less, but the biggest payoff is improved health. Navage is good personal hygiene and can help you stay healthier. At Walmart, Walgreens, CVS, Rite Aid, Target, and online. Navage, N-A-V-A-G-E. Clean nose, healthy life.
Well, it's a great honor. It's obviously not the reason I volunteer, but it's nice.
Meet Chuck Booyah, retired registered nurse, volunteer at Meals on Wheels, and another Jiffy Lube Do More winner.
And I'm Jiffy Lube owner Steve Sanner. At Jiffy Lube, we are proud to support Hoosier charities that use their vehicles to do more to make Indiana a better place to live.
Satisfying that I know that at least that day they will get a meal, maybe even two meals.
Jiffy Lube of Indiana provides all of our Do More winners with free vehicle maintenance for a year. Because now at Jiffy Lube, our trained technicians do more to keep vehicles like theirs and yours on the road. Brakes, tires, batteries, and more. As well as Indiana's favorite oil change since 1985.
You get an oil change every couple months. It's nice.
Jiffy Lube accepts competitors' coupons, so you don't have to choose between saving a few dollars versus treating your vehicle to Jiffy Lube's award-winning service. Click on JiffyLubeIndiana.com for a Jiffy Lube near you.
93.5 and 107.5, The Fan.
WIBC HD2 W298BB. WIBC HD3 W228CX, Indianapolis.
The Colts host the Los Angeles Chargers on Monday Night Football. The coverage starts at 5:30 on The Fan and 97.1 Hank FM.
It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas.
You're listening to Kevin and Querry on 93.5 and 107.5, The Fan.
Mike DeCourcy, as I have always said, and I hope he doesn't get mad when I use this title for him, the Dean of College Basketball Writers. I believe him to be, in print variation, the most authoritative voice and the most knowledgeable on college basketball, but of course also with the Big Ten Network and a noted soccer fan. In addition to that, as we bring Mike DeCourcy onto the program this morning, Mike, I know that you have always been a fan of the Pittsburgh Steelers. You and I have discussed that. You've mentioned it on the program before. Wanted to give you the opportunity to let our listeners know, as somebody who has followed the Steelers for a very long time, just what Franco Harris, who passed away this morning at the age of 72, what he meant not only to the Steelers organization, but I think truly in kind of representing the model or the mold of the Pittsburgh spirit as a city, if you will.
Yeah, Franco it was interesting because he came to the team as a first-round draft choice who had not been a great performer in college. He played in a backfield at Penn State with another player named Lydell Mitchell, who was an All-American. I think he was a Heisman finalist. Franco was always kind of viewed as sort of an underachiever. He had a great build. He was over 6 feet. He weighed 230-some pounds but had a tailback speed. And when he came to the Steelers, there were a lot of people who wondered why they selected him. And he immediately transformed the franchise. I mean, Joe Green was the cornerstone of the turnaround of the 70s decade renaissance for the Steelers. But Franco was the one whose arrival turned it around. Joe's first 3 years, I think they went 1-13, 5-9, and 6-8 in a 14-game season. And then Franco comes along, and immediately they go 11-3. He rushed for over 1,000 yards, 10 touchdowns, NFL Rookie of the Year, et cetera. And even Joe, I got a release yesterday, I think it was, from the NFL Network, which is doing Franco Harris Friday evening at 9 in their football life series. And one of the quotes from Joe was that he represented the transformation. As soon as he walked in the door, we became the Pittsburgh Steelers. And it was really like that. And he was really an important person for Pittsburgh. You have to understand what it was like to live in Pittsburgh in the 70s when the city was falling apart. I mean, the steel industry was in absolute decay and crisis. And my father worked in the steel industry, and the city was falling apart, and the Steelers were ascending to greatness, and they kept that city together. There's a book out now, and I can't remember the name of it, but it's just been released about how the Steelers saved Pittsburgh, so to speak. There's a, you know, their theory is that excellence that they represented really kept the city alive as it transformed away from the steel industry and into technology and education and medicine.
Again, Mike DeCourcy is with us. Obviously, a lot to get to with Mike, Big Ten Network. You see him on there tonight. Purdue back in action as the number one team in the nation. Mike, if you look at the start for Purdue, you're more impressed by what Zach Edey's been able to do kind of minutes-wise, stay out of foul trouble and put up, you know, pretty video game-like numbers, or what they've gotten from their freshmen early on?
Oh, I think what Zach's doing was, it's probably maybe a half leap farther than we would have expected, but he was on this track. He was a capable freshman. He was a very fine sophomore, and now he's an excellent junior. So I think that from that standpoint, although it's certainly an amazing performance what he's delivering, I don't think it's stunning. It's just, this is what happens when you get a talented basketball player with an excellent coach and coaching staff in a program that consistently makes its players better. And what Fletcher Lawyer and Braden Smith are doing is amazing, and especially Braden. And I'm not at all surprised by Fletcher's success. Fletcher comes in from a basketball family. His father was an NBA coach and scout, is an NBA coach, scout now, I believe. His brother, Foster, was really a high school superstar in Michigan, but not very tall. And I think Foster is probably 5'11", 6 feet at most, and didn't have the quickness to quite make his basketball skill work in a league like the Big Ten. So he goes to Michigan State, and he's a backup and kind of struggles a little bit. And then he goes to Davidson, where his size is not as much of an impediment, and he's an All-Atlantic 10 player. And Fletcher comes in at 6'4", so I expected him to be a good freshman because I knew he was well-trained, but I don't know that I expected him to be Purdue's second-leading scorer. Braden, for me, is the revelation because he was not, you know, he's not like a McDonald's All-American guy, and you're asking him to take over a program that wanted to contend for the Big Ten title. They had everything else in place. Brandon Newman, Ethan Morton, Mason Gillis, Trey Kaufman, Caleb First. All those guys were already there, and of course Zach. And so there was everything in place to be a contender for the Big Ten title, but they didn't have a point guard. And I remember asking Matt Painter at Media Day, you know, what are you doing there? Because I hadn't had the opportunity to go up and see him practice or anything. He said, we're fine. Braden Smith's going to be really, really good. And he has been all of that and more.
When you look at Purdue right now, and again, Mike DeCourcy joins us here on the Payless Liquors Hotline, read his work at Sporting News and on Big Ten Network. Obviously, from a resume standpoint, they deserve to be the number one team in the nation. I think there's little doubt to that. Do you view them as like I'm making a list of national title contenders, and they're in the top 2, 3, 4? Like, how do you view them, I guess, as you project them throughout the Big Ten season and into the month of March and beyond?
I think it's hard to do that at this point. If you look at the schedule, mostly because of the way the challenge series worked out, they have had the opportunity to play some very capable teams. I think going out to Portland was really important for them because, you know, they got Florida State in the challenge, so that didn't really help that much. But they go out to Portland and they play Gonzaga, Duke, West Virginia. That's three teams, that two of them which will be in competition with them seeding-wise, and one of which will, I believe, be an NCAA tournament team for sure. And they got all that work done in one weekend, so to speak. So that was really important for them, because if they hadn't gone to Portland in that tournament, I'm not sure that they would have had the level of conquest to this point that would say that they could be up there in the seedings, or the rankings, I guess, if that matters to you. But in terms of assessing what they're capable of relative to the national championship, I think that still remains to be seen. I mean, a year ago, there are certain qualities that you have to have. Nobody's won this thing without a number of NBA players, 2-3, somewhere in there. And I don't know yet whether or not Purdue has that. And if you don't have that, you basically would have to break every barrier that's been erected to that championship since, maybe 1950 or whatever. So I think that it's hard to project at that point. But we'll see how those players develop in Big Ten competition, how they handle it. I think there's no question that they can contend for the Big Ten title, and that if you win this Big Ten title with the non-conference resume that Purdue already has, there's no question. If they're Big Ten champions, they are a number one seed. I can tell you that right now. Because with what they did in non-conference, and then you add that to it, I just don't see any way they wouldn't be.
Mike, when you look at, for example, Mike DeCourcy is our guest on the Payless Cigars Hotline. We've talked a lot about with the Colts. I don't think the Colts issue is necessarily recognizing talent. It's recognizing, and this is the real trick for everybody, recognizing how to assemble talent together as a unit. Is Matt Painter as good as we have in college basketball at getting guys to buy into a team concept and understand their role, and thus then being able to take those pieces into the jigsaw puzzle? Because to me, it seems like he has guys on his roster that seemingly probably could maybe get more minutes or higher roles elsewhere, but are thrilled with their role with Purdue to ascending the basketball program. And that, to me, is the true trick of a coach. You agree?
Yeah, I think in this day, what Matt's doing is almost singular. It's amazing that he has, Brandon Newman coming off of last year would be a good example. He did not get a lot. Of all the guys who were sort of in that 10-man mix or something, I think he probably ranked 9th or 10th in minutes. And that would be a player that a lot of places would just say, okay, I'll go somewhere else, and I'll get run, and I'll get my shots, and I'll, and all of that. They didn't lose anybody. I mean, they lost the guys that were either ready to graduate or, in the case of Jaden, ready to go to the NBA and be a top four pick. That's just, like I said, it's almost unprecedented in today's college basketball for you to be able to keep a team like that intact. Matt is a special person, a special coach. He does an amazing job with that program and has for a long time. And he's one of those coaches who understands himself really well. And I still remember, I think it was maybe in some ways, at least in terms of its reflection to the public, it was 2013 or 2014 media day when he came to Chicago and stood up and said, look, I picked these players and it didn't work. And they had just finished, I think, 5-13 in the league. And he said, it's on me. And I'm going to go out and I'm going to get Purdue guys. And he went out and he continued over the next now 8 to 9 years to just continue to get more and more guys like this that are invested in being Boilers and that continue to push the program forward.
At TSN Mike on Twitter, Mike DeCourcy from Sporting News joining us here on the Payless Liquors Hotline. Shifting gears to Bloomington, Mike. Just how would you characterize the start for IU? And did we put too much stock into a team that, if they don't make some wild run in the final 8 minutes of that Michigan game in the Big Ten tournament, they probably don't make the NCAA tournament last season. We probably view Mike Woodson's first year in a much different light. Just your general thoughts on IU so far.
I think they've been the unluckiest team in America, Kevin. I mean, who else out there has had three starters miss games? And not just the guy who, set screens, but both of your point guards and your star have all missed games now. That's your problem. That's why. And that happened, not to coincide with your Elons or your early bye games, but at Rutgers, Arizona neutral, a home game against Nebraska, and then a road game at Kansas. And you're not whole for any of those games. That's brutal. I mean, I don't think that one can look at this team and say they're underachieving, because they aren't whole and haven't been for almost 3 weeks now. If I took the number of games they've lost, so they lost three from Jalen, I think, one from now two from Xavier, and one from Trace. If I took that number of games away from, you know, three top scorers on any team in America and put them through that gauntlet that Indiana went through, I don't know many teams that aren't going 1-3. I don't know there'd be any. So I'm not bothered by where they are. I think the problem is, can they get healthy and whole, and then go out and make up for a lot of lost time on who they wanted to be as a team.
Even if they were 100% healthy, Mike, the one concern I would have for Indiana, and I want you to talk me off this ledge, is I don't know that they have the consistent outside shooting. Even when Xavier Johnson was healthy, and I think he's a very good player, but he has a little John Starks in him to me, where on the nights he's good, he's really good, and on the nights he struggles, he can hurt you a little bit. But it just doesn't seem like Indiana versus other teams I see has necessarily the ball rotation on the perimeter to be able to consistently shoot from the outside and draw some pressure off of Trayce Jackson-Davis a little bit. Am I being too critical?
Well, I don't think that you're seeing any. What you're seeing isn't their full functionality. How they want to play hasn't been available for, as I said, 3 weeks now. Almost, it'll be 3 weeks on Saturday since they played the Rutgers game. It hasn't been there. I mean, they're shooting 36.3% as a team from 3-point range. They've got exit 37. Miller Kopp is hitting nearly 46. Tamar is hitting nearly 42. So to me, and Jalen's hitting nearly 36. So those are all good numbers. And to me, the big concern about them as a shooting team was, would Miller play under pressure? He had a confidence problem for his entire college career. Last year he did, all his years at Northwestern. It was always, you know, the confidence problem. And now he has persisted through the loss of those guys, not getting the high-quality shots that you'd want him to get, because the ball rotated, because Trayce got doubled and all that kind of stuff. He's continued to make shots. He made shots in that Arizona game when they needed to have them or they were going to lose by 40. He made shots at Rutgers when nobody else could put the ball in the bucket at all. He made shots last night when, again, you were down two starters. Now, I know it's Elon, but you're down two starters, and he's still making shots. I don't have that great concern about that element as long as he continues to play like that. And he's been, I mean, he hasn't had many down games. And every shooter has down games. Steph Curry has down games. But I haven't seen many from Miller. And I don't, as I said, given that a lot of those nights, the good nights for him, happened on nights when they were not themselves, I think that that's a really good sign in that department.
Mike, last one from me. And again, Mike DeCourcy, Sporting News, Big Ten Network, with us here on the Payless Liquors Hotline. Any insight into the hiring of Charlie Baker as the new NCAA president? Obviously, takes over an organization that's been heavily, heavily scrutinized. Massachusetts governor is his most recent background. So I think there was appeal, certainly from a legislation standpoint, to, you know, try and get someone with that background. What did you think of that hire?
Yeah, it kind of left me a little cold. But I understand why it went in that direction. I did an article back in May, I think it was. I talked to 8 or 9 people who have been either in or around college athletics, from Jay Billis to Oklahoma athletic director Joe Castiglione to Pitt athletic director Heather Like, and all kinds of different people who, and just basically asked them, okay, what kind of person should they get? What kind of qualifications should that person have? And the funny thing was, I don't think anybody brought up a politician. That's the, you know, I talked to like 9 different people and allowed them to just, you know, have their say. And I don't think anybody said, oh yeah, we're going to go get a sitting governor or a exiting governor. That one took, I think it took us all by surprise. I understand the importance of how legislation could help them in regards to I think the last frontier for college athletics is do the athletes become employees? And I really believe, and there's a very strong group of people on the other side of this issue. I really believe it just that there's no way that's good for college athletics if it comes to that. That the employer-employee relationship is not as healthy as the student-athlete relationship with the university, if we want to call it that. I don't think that's where it needs to go or where it should go. And I think if they could get certain elements of legislation in that they could keep it from being that. And I think that's kind of why he was hired. And we'll see whether or not he can successfully get something, you know, through Congress and through the president's desk.
Mike, have you come down from the cloud that I know you were on and watching the World Cup final?
Oh my, it was amazing! What a magnificent game! My editor was in contact with me through the game, and you know, and it being a great game made it a really harder day for me because like I had the Messi story written at halftime, like, and all I had to do was basically put in the final score, and then of course all of a sudden the whole game gets thrown up in the air with the two late French goals. And so it made it a harder day for me, but it was worth it because the game was just spectacular. But my editor says to me, okay, for the second piece we want you to do, is this the greatest World Cup final ever? And as I sat down to write my lead, I said, that's too limiting. Like, is it the greatest World Cup game? That's too limiting. I think it immediately becomes part of that conversation when you talk about 92, the Leitner shot, Kentucky Duke, or what I think was the best Super Bowl, 43 Steelers over Cardinals, or the triple overtime Celtics Suns game in the 76 NBA Finals, or the 99 Champions League when Manchester United came back from two goals down in the final minute and a half or whatever it was. Those games is where this game belongs. The best World Cup final, yeah, that's easy. It's, you know, how does it fit into the greatest games ever played in any sport? And I think it absolutely belonged in that conversation.
Just remember, yeah, Mike, when you see the aerials of Buenos Aires, just remember that is 200,000 people fewer than apparently were in Nashville for the NFL draft, according to the NFL. Don't forget it. Don't forget it. Now we have perspective.
There you go.
Mike, happy holidays if you're traveling this week. Safe travels, and always enjoy your insight.
Yeah, thank you very much. Happy holidays to everybody in Indianapolis, all my friends here. Hope you guys have a great weekend.
That is Mike DeCourcy right there on the Payless Liquors hotline. Jake, I think I would definitely push back on the injury excuse for Indiana. Have there been injuries? Without question. But you look at those three losses. I mean, it's not like you lost these games on last-second shots. I mean, 15 to Rutgers, 14 to Arizona, 22 to Kansas, and Jalen Hood-Schifino did miss those first two, but you were already getting run out of Allen Fieldhouse when Xavier Johnson went down on Saturday. So has IU been banged up? Is Trace Jackson-Davis playing through some things? Yeah, but for a team that's returned as much as they have to have suffered those three losses by the amount, to me it's how they've looked in the 120 minutes of those three games, outside of a stretch in Vegas, they have been thoroughly outplayed. That, to me, is much bigger than just the injury situation.
Indiana has very good college basketball players, undeniably. Kansas has very good NBA players, guys that will play in the NBA. Indiana has probably one guy that will make an NBA roster, and Trace Jackson-Davis.
Well, Jalen Hood-Schifino will.
And I was going to say, and another guy that will play in the NBA in Jalen Hood-Schifino. And that probably is it. Whereas, you know, when you look at the Kansas roster, I mean, they're rolling out eight guys that all, and I'm not saying they're all going to play in the NBA. I mean, there's a lot that goes into that. But their athleticism across the board and their interchangeability from one player to the other in terms of whoever has the ball being able to make plays, is a whole different level.
Yeah, now, but it's not like Rutgers has got a bunch of NBA dudes.
Fair. That's fair. And they were...
They're scoring 48 points there.
What happened against Rutgers is Indiana's, to me, the real concern about Indiana. And that is, you double down on Trace Jackson-Davis and have and challenge them, okay, beat us elsewhere. And Indiana has yet to come up with an answer for that. You know, that, by the way, is that a new Adidas hoodie that you're wearing there?
Yeah,
it looks brand new. It's very nice.
I said it yesterday, and I will get to the Adidas sweatshirt in just a second. It is amazing to watch Purdue, knowing what's coming at them every game. Double team constantly, right, to Zach Edey, and he puts up Shaquille O'Neal video game-like numbers, and yet Purdue is still so effective offensively and playing off him. Then you watch Indiana with an All-American big guy as well. Can't produce anywhere near those types of numbers. And again, offensively, they look like they've never seen a double team their lives.
Purdue has guys that have bought into their role of helping Zach Edey in that regard, that know that if it came down to it and all hell broke loose, they're capable of getting their points if need be. But they don't need to do that in order to be a part of that team.
And putting the puzzle around Edey, to your point earlier about Painter, that's a really good one. They've always done a great job of that under Matt.
I've never seen a sweatshirt so clean.
Well, if you look closely, there's a couple stains on it, actually.
It's a lovely off-white color.
Yeah, Maddie got this for me for my birthday and really likes how it looks on me.
Okay.
Well, that. Woo!
What?
Baby number three coming to the bone house.
No.
Just sharing the insight, taking you behind the scenes.
Okay. I don't think there's a single piece.
Do you want me to text Shannon and say XL? Are you XL?
I don't think there's a single piece of clothing I wear that Shannon says, I like that on you.
Trust me, there's not many. Hence why Maddie bought it for me and didn't think that anything in the closet was adhering to that.
And you immediately stained it.
Mark, you have young girls. All the clothes are just perfectly clean every...
Oh, no.
Every single day?
No, mustard stains everywhere, all kinds of stuff.
I did see last night, did you catch John Calipari did make it to that Kokomo game, him and Matt Painter in the gym?
Oh, he was there too, huh?
Remember Rake Straw was talking about it yesterday with us. Yeah. Flory Badunga, unfortunately for him, I guess was dealing with a hand injury. It was just 1 of 3 from the floor. But, Kokomo lost to Zionsville last night. So, Cal, Izzo, Painter, he's going to go down as one of the more highly rated recruits in the history of the state of Indiana.
I mean, Sean Kemp level, like, attention at this point in his career, right?
Yeah, and honestly, that's probably a comparison that's fair. Pogo stick-like, you watch him.
Yeah.
Not used to many big guys moving
like
that.
Did you ever do the pogo stick?
Yeah, not super coordinated, though, to really have it.
Do they still do pogo sticks?
I mean, they still do them. I don't know anybody that owns one doing it.
Probably on ESPN Ocho.
Do they still sell them, or have they been deemed, like, too dangerous for children?
Do you want the scooters out and the pogo sticks in?
Nah, and I'm not. I was never a pogo stick guy either, to be honest with you.
Whoa. This pop quiz looks brutal, by the way.
Pogo stick, $500.
What?
What in the blue?
Can you
hell?
Fly?
I clicked pogo stick shopping, and the first one that pops up was $499.
What are you buying? Like the Bentley of pogo sticks? I'm talking about a standard big wheel, and you're looking for the green machine.
We
don't need the green machine variation of the pogo stick.
Pogo sticks are a bit more expensive these days. $40 for a pogo stick? Will that do something for you?
Did you have a big wheel?
Yeah, I think I did.
There was always one kid in the neighborhood that had a green machine. He was like the Ricky Schroeder silver spoon kid. Mm-hmm. Always one kid had a green machine. That same kid is the same one that had like a brand new, you know, sports car when he was 16 and then was a train wreck by 20.
I thought it was cool because my big kid bike had like a AM FM radio on it.
Really?
So I can blast like Corn and Soundgarden. That kid's making too much noise over there. Quiet, ma'am.
You had a radio on your bike?
It was a Huffy. Yeah, it was like that was the bike. That was the best Christmas gift I ever got. Was the Huffy bike from Santa and had AM FM radio on it.
So could you turn it out while you were riding?
Yeah.
Well, that seems
dangerous.
You
turn it up. You could. It was right in the middle, right between the handlebars.
Well, that seems very dangerous.
It's very cool. Oh, you do no hands? Come on, that's easy.
We will begin our morning check down here again. Pop quiz.
Wait, where
7.
Was the antenna? That seems
there wasn't
like
an antenna.
Oh, wow. Yeah. Impressive.
317-239-1070. Again, the pop quiz coming up here in a few. For now, though, and again, this is a brutal pop quiz. Just brutal by Scotty right before the holiday season. For now, morning checkdown.
The morning checkdown brought to you by Ball State Basketball. Get your tickets at ballstatesports.com on 93.5 and 107.5 The Fan.
We'll begin, by the way, with Mark Dykton offering us some, I guess, breaking news to an extent about both of the pro sports franchises in town, right?
Yeah, so Zach Kiefer, 4 minutes ago, said a change on the depth chart at QB for the Colts. Sam Ellinger has moved into the two spot behind Matt Ryan. Nick Foles had been working as Ryan's backup the last few weeks, so...
Look, I'm seeing a little correction here from the Colts, though, on that. Yeah, J.J. Stankovic right here, Colts.com writer. That was a mistake on my part. Foles is number two and Ellinger is number three.
Okay, well, forget that one then.
So, then Colts quarterback depth chart shuffling.
Now, wait a minute.
Shockingly doesn't.
You got to be careful with the published depth chart for the Colts, right?
It can be a dicey situation there. So,
just saying.
Yeah,
but then,
a little dicey there.
If you're a Pacers fan, sounds like good news. If you're a cable cord cutter.
But that
cutter,
worked out, didn't it, Kevin?
Yes.
If you're
blessing in disguise.
If you're a cord-cutting Pacers fan, this looks like there's some good news on the horizon, especially if you're a Fubo TV subscriber. A deal with Fubo TV and Sinclair to carry Bally Sports RSNs. All 19 RSNs will be available on Fubo TV.
Fubo TV?
Yeah. So it's
I'm not familiar with that.
Fubo TV is a very heavy sports-related TV streaming service. I mean, they have regular channels, but...
In the basement, you come down to the basement of my man cave. Mm-hmm. I've got the foo bar, and then we watch that.
I was just waiting for a foo bar, foo boo. Where else are we going with this?
Well,
that's a step in the somewhat right direction.
Yeah, all 19 Bally Sports branded RSNs will be on Fubo TV next month.
There you go.
So now do YouTube TV and Hulu, and we're all set. We're rolling.
Speaking of the Pacers, tonight in Boston, 7:30 tip. They are a 10-point underdog. Again, they'll see Malcolm Brogdon tonight. He's had a pretty nice start to his Boston career, being utilized off the bench. Boston's actually lost 4 of 5, along with Indiana. But yeah, 10-point favorite, the Celtics tonight. It'll be at Miami on Friday, and then at New Orleans on Monday. So a tough 3-game stretch coming up for the Pacers.
People want to see pictures of this bike I got. Okay.
Yeah, I was going to say.
Oh, wait, they don't want to see the sweatshirt?
Well, I mean, you're on, just stand up and show it off.
That's right.
On the YouTube stream.
College basketball yesterday, Indiana over Elon, 96-72. It was Purdue Fort Wayne, 83-59 over Southern Indiana. The Eagles now 7-6. IUPUI getting their third win of the year, 62-52. They were winners in the Indiana Classic at Fort Wayne, and they beat Texas A&M Commerce. Who's 4-9.
Oh, by the way, Corey texted me earlier. Said he went to Texas A&M Commerce.
Really?
Used to be called East Texas State. Let me find his text here. But it's not Corpus Christi. Remember I was saying that earlier? Okay. I'm like, is that Corpus Christi? He goes, Commerce is its own campus near Dallas. Used to be East Texas State. Corpus Christi is still a campus down on the Gulf in South Texas.
I don't think.
Which that makes sense because they're called the Islanders.
Is Dallas in East Texas?
Is it due west somewhere?
I guess everything's west or east of the Panhandle.
That's a big state.
You know, if you meet anybody from Texas, you ask them if they live near the Panhandle. You just say that automatically.
Mm-hmm. Did we talk about Purdue and New Orleans yet?
No.
9 o'clock tip. Privateers of New Orleans send up to Mackey, 33.5-point underdog, New Orleans. They're 3-7 on the year. IUPUI by 3 points is their only Division I win. Butler beat them by 26.
Has New Orleans always been the Privateers? Like when Irvin Johnson played there, were they the Privateers? Okay.
Scotty's nodding his head.
I don't know why that seemed odd to me.
What else? Franco Harris passed at the age of 72 overnight. We talked a little bit about that with Mike DeCourcy. Again, just kind of an eerie, honestly, feeling to it all, considering that this Saturday night, the 50th anniversary of the Immaculate Reception, Raiders at Steelers. It's the Christmas Eve night game. So far, no cause of death has been released at the age of 72. Franco Harris. And I guess I just kind of forgot this in the meaning of the Immaculate Reception, Jake. That was their first playoff win.
Yeah.
You know, you think if that play doesn't happen, do the Steelers
kind of
go on?
Catapulted them off and run,
yeah,
right?
As historic of a run as they did.
Boy, they've had some... I mean, that team, as Mike had mentioned, and the way that they were built, but that, I think it was 74, Scotty will know for sure. The 74 draft, was it, Scott? What year was the draft?
Yeah.
Lambert, Lynn Swan, Stallworth, and Jack Ham, maybe?
Yeah.
Or I don't know. There were four of them. Donnie Shell? We'll look it up. It was amazing. I mean, four Hall of Famers in one draft is amazing.
Scotty, this pop quiz is straight coal in the stocking.
Well, thank you, he says.
Takes that as a compliment. 317-239-1070. Pop quiz is next.
Free battery testing, free battery charging, and replacement batteries that fit your needs. That's what makes AutoZone America's number one battery destination. Get in the zone. AutoZone.
Yo, Pablo Torre here, host of the ESPN Daily Podcast. When you want to go beyond your feed, when you want to get inside the score, when you want to get behind the highlight, there's ESPN Daily. Go deeper into the stories of the moment. Get the exclusive access and insider perspective that only ESPN can give you. ESPN Daily, hosted by me, Pablo Torre. Listen and subscribe wherever you get your podcasts.
Dell Technologies' Days of Deals for Business start now with fresh, limited quantity deals on tech to drive productivity. Save on select performance laptops and desktops powered by 12th Gen Intel Core processors. Don't forget special pricing on the latest monitors, docks, and accessories, plus free shipping on everything and special financing with Dell Business Credit. Call a Dell Technologies advisor at 877-ASK-DELL. That's 877-ASK-DELL. 877-ASK-DELL.
Santa Barkley is back, and this year he's giving new FanDuel customers exactly what you wanted. Hey, it's Mark from Kevin and Query. Unwrap the gift of a no-sweat first bet up to $2,500 back in free bets when you sign up with promo code Mark, M-A-R-C. That's up to $2,500 back if your first bet doesn't win. Now is the perfect time to give FanDuel a shot if you haven't already. The app is safe, secure, and easy to use. They're always giving you great promotions. And when you win, you get paid instantly. Some of my favorite things on FanDuel are the same game parlays, the everyday odds, boosts, and specials that go across multiple sports. They also have live betting, so games that have already started, you'll get updated odds there. So check it all out on FanDuel. See why it's America's number one sportsbook. And get in the holiday spirit with a no-sweat first bet up to $2,500 back in free bets from Santa Barkley, a.k.a. Charles Barkley, when you sign up with promo code Mark, M-A-R-C. 21 and over and present in Indiana. First online real money wager only. Refund issued is now withdrawable free bets that expire in 14 days. Restrictions apply. See terms at sportsbook.fanduel.com. Gambling problem? Call 1-800-9-WITH-IT.
Will they find a home? Sponsored by Geico. Jane doesn't mind an apartment with no elevator.
5 flights of stairs is 5 flights of cardio.
Bob is a little less enthusiastic about stairs.
I hate stairs.
Compromise is tough, but these two won't have to compromise when they bundle renters and car insurance with Geico. It's easy, and they could save even more. In the end, Jane and Bob found an apartment that's a 4-story walk-up. And Bob?
Yeah, there's a freight elevator she doesn't know about.
What were you talking about?
Nothing.
Bundling without compromise at geico.com.
Gather near and bring the cheer this holiday season. Dazzle and delight the love of your life with a gift from Helzberg Diamonds. Don't miss great prices on stunning diamond studs, tennis bracelets, gemstone rings, and the year's must-have look, gold jewelry for stacking and layering. Another reason to go to Helzberg? Get a free Microsoft Surface Laptop Go with a purchase of $1,699 or more. Visit Helzberg.com or a store near you today. Limited time offer while supplies last. See online or in store for details.
The reality is, though, that winning that game would have done them nothing. To have the resiliency, the guts, the fortitude, the leadership of men.
I know I can lead men.
To reach down deep inside and still allow Minnesota to keep them within the striking distance of the top six in the draft.
If you're talking about it.
It takes a special skill set to be able to do it that way.
We're talking about it.
They can actually move up another spot tonight.
Your home for Indy sports, 93.5 and 107.5, The Fan. Have you studied? Can you handle the pressure? Sharpen your pencils. It's time for the Pop Quiz with Kevin and Query. Brought to you by Jiffy Lube, Indiana's favorite oil change since 1985.
This isn't that hard.
What?
Nah, it's not that hard.
If you,
I expect zero hints.
I was gonna say, if you give zero hints and you know a man of your word was saying that, then let's see how someone does on it.
I'm just telling you.
Will you give out hints?
No, I don't believe I need to give out hints.
All right,
I'm not gonna be a snake like that, right?
Mark, how about you? A number 1 through 8.
Shaking his head. Somebody just comes through like a bolt of lightning, right?
What?
Okay, Nate, you're already giving out hints.
I didn't say that.
Mm-hmm.
Mark,
mm-hmm.
Number 1 through 8.
Let's go to number 2, Scott.
Scott.
2 shows left.
Scott, what's up?
Hey, can you hear me?
Turn your radio down, Scott.
Sorry about that. The Bluetooth kicked off.
All good. Scott, what do you do for a living?
I sit on the phone and sling loans all over the country.
Nice. My wife used to sling freight, she used to describe it, working in the logistics world.
Now, Scott, do I hear a little one in the background?
Yeah, he's back there.
Are you working from home today, or are you driving around slinging loans?
Driving around, heading in.
Hands are on 10 and 2, right?
You know it.
Okay. And the name of the little one is what?
Blake.
And how old's Blake?
8.
Blake, what's up? Blake can't hear me, I realize.
So is Blake on holiday break now, Scott?
Say it again.
Blake on holiday break, I assume?
He is.
Nice.
What is Blake's number one item that he's hoping Santa Claus delivers here within the week?
Walkie-talkies.
I like that.
Secret Santa walkie-talkies.
Is he interested in a $500 pogo stick?
How about a bike with a radio on it?
That thing was sweet.
All right, Scott, that would you like for me... Bike, yeah. Scott, are you native to Indianapolis, by the way?
No. I've been here for 20-some-odd years, but no.
And in terms of your move to Indianapolis, what was her name?
Oh. No, I came for college. Oh,
Scott, okay. did you used to live by Tech High School by chance? This was a little random.
Actually, I still do, kind of.
Okay, a buddy of mine said that you did his loan. Just texted me.
Oh, yeah, the next-door neighbor. Well, I helped him when he moved down south.
I love it. Yeah, it lives just north of Atlanta right now. Just had a little girl named Lucy the other day.
Yep.
Nice. Look at this connection here. Scott, I hope you have a very successful pop quiz.
Where did you grow up, Scott?
I bounced around a little bit as an Army brat, but graduated high school from Huntington.
Okay. Here we go. Would you like for me or Kevin to lead you off with question number one?
Kevin, let's change it up a little bit.
All right, Scott, on this day in 1941, this team became the first to win NFL championship games in consecutive seasons. Packers, Giants, Redskins, Bears.
Bears.
Question number two. Name the sport that was first played on this day in 1891. If I had to guess, I'd say it probably was in Springfield, Massachusetts. Was it auto racing, jumping, basketball, or volleyball?
Basketball.
Oh, it's so easy.
Yeah, so easy. Packers win over the Rams on Monday Night Football, Scott. Was Green Bay's 14th consecutive victory in the month of December. Green Bay's streak is tied for the second longest. I can tell Blake is a big Packers fan. Green Bay's streak tied for the second longest December winning streak in NFL history. Name the only team to win more NFL games in a row in the month of December. Packers, Chargers, Patriots, or Dolphins?
Patriots.
Okay, question number four.
Scotty.
Former Steeler running back Franco Harris, as we had mentioned, passing away overnight at the age of 72. He is most known for the Immaculate Reception, of course, that has been labeled the most famous play in football. But exactly how far was the play of the Immaculate Reception? Was it a 40-yard touchdown, a 50-yard touchdown, a 60-yard touchdown, or a 70-yard touchdown?
Some reason, I believe it was like 39, so I'll say 40.
I'll tell you this. 12 years ago, Franco Harris was the age of the number of yards it was.
60.
Okay. Scott's a smart fella there. You can tell the lone world Scott has mastered. Number five, Scott, name the Raider whose touchdown with 1:17 left in the game set up Harris's heroics in the Immaculate Reception game. Ken Stabler, Marv Hubbard, Fred Blickenoff, or Charlie Smith?
Not Stabler, not Charlie's, not Blitkoff, that'd be too easy. B.
Hubbard?
Hubbard, yep.
My buddy says you're a big IndyCar fan, Scott?
Did we lose Scott?
I'm still here,
huge fan.
Huge fan. You enjoy Jake's calls?
Yeah, I do. I'm usually out there in turn three with some of the other crazies.
There you go.
Hey, that's the place to be, man. We appreciate it, Scott. Appreciate it very much. I also appreciate the subdued enthusiasm in saying you like my calls. The Chicago Bears was, in fact, correct for question
number one. He's juggling a lot in his car right now, Jake.
Dr. Naismith in the Rules of Basketball are on display at Allen Fieldhouse in Lawrence. Correcto. That was correct. The San Diego Chargers, though, was the answer for number three.
That was a tough one.
60 yards was correct for the Immaculate Reception, and it was the snake, Kenny Stabler, for question number five.
Scott Blake.
Chargers, go.
Happy holidays. Good luck on the walkie-talkie front from Santa. We come back, speaking of basketball, the Elam ending. You've seen in the NBA All-Star Game. We're going to see it this week out in the G League Showcase out in Vegas. Any update on if it could become permanent, the professional basketball world? We'll talk to the creator of it, Nick Elam, next.
Hey, Alexa, you want to go out with me?
Fat chance. Dog breath.
Okay, I was just, you know, just asking.
If you want to do the smart thing, say, Alexa, play 107.5 The Fan.
Now that's smart.
So I switched to Boost Mobile and got this free Samsung Galaxy A23 5G phone.
Why do you think they call it the Galaxy?
Maybe because the Samsung Galaxy A23 has a huge screen, and galaxies are huge gravitationally bound systems of stars rotating around a supermassive black hole.
And the phone is free?
When you switch to Boost Mobile.
Cool. You lost me at gravitationally bound.
Switch to Boost and get a free Samsung Galaxy A23 5G phone. Boost Mobile. Unleash your power. Limited time offer while supplies last. New customers only. Excludes tax. One device offer per line. Only available on certain networks. 5G not available everywhere. Additional restrictions apply. See your local Boost Mobile store for details.
Peacock presents the new original limited series, The Best Man. The final chapters from the creator of The Best Man and The Best Man Holiday and executive producer of Insecure. The series reunites the original cast to wrap up all the unfinished business with new loves, career highs, parenthood, grief, and everything in between. The series explores what threatens to tear us down and what ultimately keeps us together. Coming this week, stream The Best Man, The Final Chapters, only on Peacock.
With one of the best savings rates in America, banking with Capital One is the easiest decision in the history of decisions. Even easier than choosing Slash to be in your band.
Next up for lead guitar. You're in.
Cool.
Yep, even easier than that. And with no fees or minimums on checking and savings accounts, is it even a decision? That's banking reimagined. What's in your wallet?
Terms apply. See CapitalOne.com/bank for details. Capital One N.A. member FDIC.
At Lowe's, every pro is an MVP to us. That's why MVP's Pro Rewards members can earn bonus points on select products and brands like Power Pro, Weehawk, and Valspar. Then redeem your bonus points for exciting rewards like tools, sports memorabilia, Lowe's e-gift cards, and more. Join Lowe's MVP's Pro Rewards today to start earning. Bonus points calculated before taxes and fees after applicable discounts, if any, subject to program terms. While supplies last, points expire at end of calendar year. Visit Lowe's.com/L/Pro loyalty terms for details. Now through 1-823.
Remember when you were in your prime and you could work and play hard on a daily basis? Guys, it's time to get that magic back. If you're ready to feel great again, go see Affinity. Affinity Whole Health is the leader in testosterone and hormone replacement therapy. When you start with Affinity, you'll see a jump in your energy, mental focus, and drive. Get started for free at feelgreatindy.com. Then the full hormonal blood panel and medical consult is just $99. Go to feelgreatindy.com today.
All your last-minute holiday needs are at Payless Liquors. Jim Beam 12 Days of Whiskey is $6.99, and Stirling's 12 Days of Cocktails $34.99. Plus, Payless has assorted candy canes, great for parties and gifts. And all 26 Payless stores have Kendall Jackson Vintner's Reserve Chardonnay for $9.99 a bottle, and Svedka Aiden Proof in the large 1.75 liter for only $14.99. Payless Liquors, open late on Christmas Eve, and select stores open Christmas Day. Don't pay more, get more, and pay less at Payless Liquors.
This holiday season, Diamonds Direct gives you the gift of 0% interest financing for 3 years on any purchase. With high prices and high interest rates everywhere else, Diamonds Direct is here with the incredible shopping experience you need. Our guaranteed best value prices will save you money. And with 0% interest, you can spread your payments over 3 years with no finance charge, period. And for this holiday season, we're showcasing an expanded selection of affordable and timeless holiday gifts. Rings, earrings, pendants, bracelets, colored gemstones. And if you're upgrading her diamond or getting engaged over the holidays, we have one of the largest diamond selections in America. All sizes and shapes, all cut for maximum brilliance, and all offered at our amazing direct importer, no middleman prices. Check out our holiday gift guide now at DiamondsDirect.com. Buy now or come into the showroom. Let one of our experts guide you in finding the holiday gift that's at the top of their list. And enjoy 3 years zero interest financing on any holiday purchase. Diamonds Direct. Your love, our passion.
I stopped smoking with Mark Patrick's hypnosis when nothing else worked. 1 year later, my wife Michelle and I attended the Mark Patrick Weight Loss Hypnosis Seminar. In 2 months, lost 43 pounds, and she lost 18 pounds.
And we feel great.
Seminars January 19th at the Holiday Inn Express and Suites in Noblesville. Weight loss 5:30, stop smoking 8 p.m. Or January 21st at the Holiday Inn Indianapolis Airport. Weight loss 11 a.m., stop smoking 2 p.m. Register at markpatrickseminars.com.
Listen to The Ride with JMV from 3 to 6 this week, and you could win two tickets to New Year's Eve with Yacht Rock Review on Saturday, December 31st at the Murat Theater, and two tickets to see the Zac Brown Band August 6th at Ruoff Music Center.
The Pacers are in Boston to take on the powerful Celtics tonight at 7 on 93.5 and 107.5 The Fan.
Chestnuts roasting on an open fire, Jack Frost nipping at your nose.
You're listening to Kevin and Querry on 93.5 and 107.5, The Fan.
A classic there from Mark Dykton, bringing us back one final time, and a bit fitting in a way, because if you look at how Nick Elum has thought about the game of basketball, he could be changing a whole lot from a traditional standpoint and how NBA games potentially end. Again, Nick Elum, the professor from Ball State, you've heard him on these airwaves before. It's kind of an annual conversation we have, and love to get an update on where things stand. He has created the Elum ending. You've seen it in the NBA All-Star game. You've seen it in the tournament that gets played during the summer, some G League stuff as well. And Nick Elum joins us right now on the Payless Liquors hotline. Nick, good morning. Thank you for the time. And I feel like just every conversation with you should start there. The elevator pitch to those that have not heard before. What is the Elum ending?
Well, it's great to be back with you. Yeah, the Elum ending in a nutshell is that you play most of the game with the game clock. You play the last part of the game without a game clock. And the idea is not to change basketball, really. It's to do the opposite, to preserve a more natural and exciting style of play. Through the end of every game, it gets rid of the fouling and the stalling and the sloppy play that we're often used to seeing during the final stretches of games. It allows more opportunity for a late comeback, and every game ends with the swish of a net, so you get a lot more memorable game-ending moments. That's how it's supposed to work on paper, and that's how it's worked in practice ever since it was first implemented at TPT in 2017. And here we are, 5 to 6 years later, and really starting to see the concept grow throughout the basketball world.
So basically, let's say third quarter ends, and Kevin Bowen's team has 63, Jake Query's team has 58. You pick out a number, let's say 25, and you are adding 25 points to that 63 number. So now it's the first one to 88 wins. My team has 63. We need to score 25. Jake's team has 58. They need to score 30. First team to 88 then wins. No time on the clock.
That's the way it works in G League. Yes, they're playing a version of the Elum ending where there's no clock at all in the fourth quarter. Just like you said, it's a plus 25 format.
So it is. So that kind of answers my question here, Nick. But for example, like in soccer, when you get extra time, you don't know how long the extra time is. In every single game, the point that is added or the desired point is the same formula from every game. It does not vary on the flow of that particular game, correct?
That's right. And it's interesting you ask that, because when I first devised this concept back in 2007 and had some of my preferred versions were where that point total would be adjustable. You know, if you got a lower scoring game, you'd add a lower number. But if it was a higher scoring game, you got a higher number. I kind of like that variability. And I guess customizability, but as years went on, I wasn't really getting a lot of traction in getting that idea embraced. I started to go to another idea that was in the reserve, which is where, you would just add a flat number for all games. And actually, once I started to promote that version, it actually got a little more well-received right away. Just the simplicity of it, I think people enjoy. So here we are seeing it now, that it is that flat number that's being used.
So basically, at some point, it becomes a race to who gets to 25 first, but the team that trails has X number of points to even get to zero. Does that make sense what I'm saying?
Yeah, exactly. And that's,
so in other words, if I got an 18-point lead, then what that means is, okay, now I just got to get to 25, and this other guy's got to get to 25, but he's got to score 18 points just to get to zero to begin with. So now I have a 43-point lead, basically.
Yeah, that's a fair way, but absolutely.
Again, Nick Elam is with us. Day job, Ball State prof, but in the sports world, known as the guy that came up with the Elam ending. Several people in the NBA world absolutely love it. I know Chris Paul has been a big advocate for it. Nick, what do you hear from, like, biggest pushback against it? Is it simply we have tradition and we have stats and a record book to uphold? Is that, like, the biggest pushback?
I don't hear the stats pushback really at all. I think, a lot of those concerns that were around are starting to fade away. And I remember... And I think that's just as more and more people see it in practice. I think they are, starting to embrace it. But yeah, when you hear about it or read about it, just kind of on paper, yeah, I think there's some pushback. And I remember when it was first being implemented, a lot of people thought that the Elam ending wouldn't even be able to accomplish its primary objective, which is to eliminate that fouling strategy by the trailing team. A lot of people thought, well, instead of doing that fouling at the very end of the game, now they're going to start to foul as the time portion of the game winds down. It's just going to move that fouling up earlier to the game. And I always thought, well, I don't think that's going to happen because, it's more likely to widen your deficit than narrow your deficit. And under the regular format, even though that's true, you still have no choice. Like, you still got to foul, or otherwise the clock's just going to run out and the game's going to be over. Well, with the Elam ending, you don't have to foul. You're going to have that other final stretch, that untimed final stretch after the clock runs out. So there's really no reason to hand 3 points away and foul. So what we saw is that strategy's never really been used. I don't think it ever would be used. But again, that's just one example of some concerns that people had going into implementation that are starting to fade away once they see how it works.
Again, Nick Elam is our guest. The Elam ending is going to be implemented. Last thing here, Nick, and I appreciate your time this morning in our final minute. Do you foresee that, in fact, this will become something that we are more and more familiar with? Because is there the possibility at any level that this will become the adopted finality towards games?
So I wish I was really part of the inner circle who could tell you a definitive answer there, but... what I can tell you is that people who are in the inner circle have kind of kept me in the loop a little bit indirectly, and some of the steps in the process are already coming true. One of them told me a few years ago that they said, just be patient, give it time. And what he saw is the progression. He said, what I think is going to happen is you're going to first see it in overtime in the G League, and you're going to see it in regulation in the G League. Then you're going to see it in overtime in the NBA, and then you're finally going to see it in regulation in the NBA. Well, right now, this season, and especially this week, we're starting to see those early steps of that process come through. We've seen it experimented in overtime in the G League now this week and all the games during the fourth quarter. And it's proving itself to be solid and oftentimes spectacular on the court. And if it continues to be embraced as it has, then those final steps of the process might come through of actually seeing it in NBA play.
It's got to be pretty cool to see those first steps there. Nick, as I've said to you over the years, it's an absolutely fascinating idea. I love watching games that have it. I think it's just great, great drama and really, really good entertainment. So enjoy the G League Showcase. Happy holidays and safe travels.
Thanks so much. You too.
That's Nick Elam right there on the Payless Liquors Hotline. Jake, when you watch the end of these games, it's like any of us that have played a game to 11 or 21 with our buddies. Think about, little pucker factor in having to hit the shot to get to 11.
Pucker factor.
To get to 21. You see some pressure. I mean, we see it in the All-Star game. You guys watch the fourth quarter of the NBA All-Star game? How different it's been with the Elam ending?
Yeah, you're right.
Fun drama.
It's cool.
If you take anything away from the show today, pucker factor.
That's okay.
You guys good at that idea? NBA overtime adopts it?
Yeah, I would.
I think it's good during the regular season.
Just remove the pucker factor.
Ryan Walters, Purdue football head coach, tomorrow, 9 o'clock. Everybody have a great day.